Today in Lincoln, Nebraska, a game of major importance in the national championship picture as the winner of this Big Eight showdown takes a large step toward the conference title and the Orange Bowl. Share the lead in the Big Eight with identical records of 4-0. The winner of this one is likely to win the Big Eight title and the berth in the Orange Bowl. Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome. I'm Sean McDonald. We're delighted to have you with us on ESPN. Nebraska is unbeaten at 8-0, but the critics say they haven't played a very tough schedule. They'll be tested today against Colorado. Nebraska still looking for its first national championship under Tom Osborne. A win today, and they could be playing for it on New Year's Day. Meanwhile, Colorado looking for back-to-back Big Eight titles, but they haven't won here in Lincoln since 1967. These two teams quite similar. Down to the locker room, Coach Mike Gottfried has more on that subject.
Thanks, Sean. We're in the Nebraska locker room, and here in a couple minutes when they come back from the field, they're going to go on this blackboard and just go over their game plan. They've worked it all week. They know exactly what they want to try to do against Colorado, vice versa, in Colorado's locker room. But at halftime is where this really comes into play, because at halftime, the coaches will assemble the defensive unit here, the offensive unit over here, and go over the changes that they need to make in the second half. And whoever makes the most changes and the most accurate changes has the best chance to affect the second half and win the football game. Just to look at the game plan as I see it, the Nebraska offense, I look for them to play a lot of power eye offensive formations today. Lance Lewis be a key player, Mickey Joseph also. The offensive line is a big offensive line for Nebraska. The key is going to be whether they can handle the movement of the Colorado defensive line. The Colorado defensive line will move almost all the time. Joel Steed, Gary Howell, Marcellus Elder, to try to open up the linebackers to get some clean hits. Expect the option, the fullback game, a power game, a play-action passing game out of Nebraska. Weather will be a factor in this football game. Rain doesn't bother you as much as the wind. From a coaching standpoint, the wind, the kicking game, the quarterback throwing the ball in the wind, that'll be the biggest factor. Move over here to the Colorado offense. They'll play exactly the same kind of offensive system that Nebraska does. It's a fullback-oriented, a power, play-action option. George Hemingway's got to be a big factor in this ball game, blocking and carrying the football. Darian Hagan also. When you look at Nebraska's defense, the key will be that they will play the defensive ends inside out of the tackles, which means the defensive ends and the nose guard will be responsible for the fullback on the option play. The linebackers, the inside and the outside, will have the quarterback. The safeties will be responsible for the pitch. The matchup to watch for, Kenny Walker versus Ariel Solomon. Kenny Walker is very quick. Back to you, Sean.
Coach Gottfried highlighted the two outstanding blocking fullbacks, George Hemingway and Lance Lewis. They'll be leading the way today for two of the leading rushers in the nation. Eric Bieniemy of Colorado is the leading rusher in the nation at 153.5 yards per ball game. Leotis Flowers, the eye back for the Cornhuskers, seventh in the nation at 126.2 yards per game. You saw Mike in the warm, dry Nebraska locker room, a study in contrast down on the sidelines, and our colleague, Kevin Guthrie.
Thanks, Sean. As you look at the field, it's obviously going to be slippery. The rain is staying a little bit ahead of the drainage. Big Eight football at its finest. This is why the successful teams in this conference don't pass the football. Yesterday, we were talking to Tom Osborne. He says they get 3 days with weather a year. We got all the elements. We got wind, we got cold, we got rain. As Coach Gottfried said, the most important of those is the wind. It's gusting, it's 25 miles an hour, and it's swirling. With two great teams like this, a lot of the time it comes down to special teams. A year ago, the game was decided by the kicking game. The wind plays a big role there, and it's going to play a big role today. I'm going to have fun down here. Try not to get electrocuted. Sean, you and Mike have a good time up there in the press box.
Thank you, Kevin. Moments ago, the Cornhuskers of Nebraska took the field. This, their final home game of the season, the final game at Memorial Stadium for the Nebraska seniors. ESPN's presentation of CFA football, Colorado versus Nebraska, is being brought to you by New West, skin scent for him, created by Aramis. By Gold MasterCard, the best gold card to master the moment. And by Heil Furnaces, the energy savers. The Buffaloes take the field. We'll have the opening kickoff from Lincoln, Nebraska in just a moment.
So, who's the computer for?
For my daughter. College.
There are moments when Gold MasterCard makes a difference.
No, I got this one.
That's my dad.
With more buying power and the best buyer protection.
My skateboard.
Master Purchase covers you for 90 days against loss, theft, or breakage.
Dad?
If anything happens, one phone call will replace it.
Maybe I should carry this one, Dad.
Gold MasterCard, the best gold card to master the moment.
On a night like this, you'll be grateful for a safety feature found in almost every Chrysler car you rent from Thrifty. A safety feature Thrifty hopes you'll never see. It's an airbag. That's right, an airbag. In about half the time it takes to blink your eye, this airbag can inflate and save your life. At Thrifty, we take safety as seriously as savings. Thrifty, because it's your money.
There are those who thirst for something different, something beyond the ordinary. For them, there is a beer that refreshes like no other. Michelob Dry. Once you've experienced its bold taste, with no aftertaste, there's no going back.
Hey! When you're out street hiking, you better know how to read the terrain. First, trust your instincts. By all means, avoid distractions. Do your best to preserve the wildlife, because street hikers don't just walk, they hike.
Fresh shoes, Joe.
This game is critical, has paramount importance. We want to win back-to-back Big 8 championships. We want to go back to the Orange Bowl. We've had a difficult season. It's been a trying season, but we've got a lot of talent. We're ambitious. This team has a strong resolve. If we get anything short of victory, it's going to be a major disappointment.
Those the thoughts of Colorado coach Bill McCartney last night. The Buffaloes won the toss and deferred their decision to the second half. Nebraska will get the football first. Nate Turner on the left of your screen, Tyrone Hughes on the right, ready to receive the opening kickoff from Jim Harper. The wind, a problem. The ball blown off the tee. And Harper will likely require a holder.
Sean, you get two quarters in this game where you're going to have the wind as a factor, so you got to make the most of your two quarters where you get it. Kicking game-wise to try to now Colorado to pin Nebraska in and not let them out, get field position and win that game right off the bat. So two quarters you got to win. Tom Osborne knows he needs to use this win as much as he can.
In his 18th season as head man at Nebraska, his offense will indeed be heading into the wind. In the first quarter, short kick taken by Tyrone Hughes. He's out to the 26-yard line. That's where the Nebraska offense begins first and 10, led by junior quarterback Mickey Joseph, the fullback Lewis, the I-back Leotis Flowers, the wideouts Bostic and Turner, Turner a wingback, the tight end William Washington. David Edeal is the center,
The guards, Jim Wanek and Will Shields, and the tackles, Tom Punt and Brian Boerboom. Nebraska into a 25-mile-per-hour wind in the first quarter. Flowers on the first play from scrimmage, lost the football. Buffalo saying they have recovered. But they have not. Will Shields, the starting right guard, came up with the ball for Nebraska. Colorado defensively, the tackles Elder and Howe. The nose man, Joel Steed. Great outside linebackers in Williams and McGee. On the inside, Bakert and Johnson. The corners, McLuhan and Figures. The safeties, James and Thomas. Credit Leotis Flowers with a gain of 2 on first down. Flowers again. Across the 30 and down at the 31. Wrapped up by Terry Johnson. He's starting today for Chad Brown, who's back in Boulder due to mononucleosis. Colorado's defense has had trouble early in ball games. The opponents have scored first in 8 of the 9 games the Buffaloes have played this year. Third down, a long 5, nearly 6 for Nebraska. Joseph threw only 4 times last week against Iowa State. He's not trying to throw, and he's down for a 6-yard loss back to the 25. And this should be interesting, Coach, as Nebraska has to punt into the 25-mile-an-hour breeze.
Well, you watch here, the containment by Alfred Williams right here, not letting Mickey Joseph outside. The whole play was a run from the start where Mickey Joseph faked inside and tried to get outside.
Dave McLuhan back deep. He has returned 2 punts for touchdowns this year. Mike Stigge is the punter for Nebraska. The wind knocks it down. McLuhan lets it bounce down by the Cornhuskers at the 49-yard line. Great field position, and the wind at the Buffaloes' backs as they come on offense for the first time. Darian Hagan is the quarterback, the junior from Los Angeles. The fullback, Hemingway. The great tailback, Bieniemy. The receivers, Pritchard and Simmons. The tight end, Sean Brown. An outstanding offensive line centered by Jay Lewenberg. The guards, Joe Garten, an All-American, and Brian Campbell. The tackles, Solomon and Vanderpool.
There was a penalty on that punt, and it was turned down by Colorado as a legal procedure. Colorado's got excellent field position, as I said earlier. They need to make the most of the quarter. They have the win.
Just as Nebraska started with Flowers, Colorado begins with Bieniemy, and he's into Nebraska territory. A 6-yard gain on first down for Eric Bieniemy. Defensively for the Cornhuskers, Joe Sims and Kenny Walker are the tackles. Walker is deaf. The nose guard, Pat Engelbert. The outside linebackers, Hill and Kroll. Kroll will be a first-round draft pick in the NFL. Inside, it's Petko and Tyrants. The corners, Bruce Pickens and Tahan Lewis. The safeties, Reggie Cooper and Tyrone Bird. Tom Osborne says this is the best defense he's had in his 18 years at Nebraska. Bieniemy through the middle with a first down at the 37 of Nebraska.
As I said early in the ball game, watch the fullbacks because they're going to be asked to block. Here, George Hemingway leads with a good block and opens up Bieniemy on the isolation play. Watch the defensive ends, both Joe Sims and Kenny Walker. They're going to be taking inside charges here to try to take that play away.
First and 10, Colorado. We've played 2.5 minutes, no score. Eric Bieniemy down at the 31-yard line. Again, quality yardage on first down, and that's been the story of the season for the Buffaloes. For the year, Eric Bieniemy on the Colorado offense averaging more than 6 yards per first down play. And last week against Oklahoma, they averaged better than 10 yards per play on first down. Flagged down on this first down play.
I think it's a personal foul.
It is. John Laurie of Springfield, Missouri, the referee, leading this Big 8 officiating crew. Mike, how about the decision right on the coin toss?
Bill McCartney won it. He really did the right thing, forced Tom Osborne to choose between the ball and the wind.
Well, most teams, when they win the toss in college football, will defer, because in the second half, you have a better idea of what both the offenses and defenses are doing. So right off the bat, you want the ball in the second half. So that's the reason they deferred. But plus, they got the wind because Nebraska chose to take the ball.
If Tom Osborne took the wind, he gives Bill McCartney the ball to start each half, and certainly did not want to do that. So he took the ball. It had the punt after three plays. Colorado got it in a great field position, and the Buffaloes are threatening after the walk-off of the personal foul, first and 10 at the 17-yard line. The enemy again squirts down to the 12-yard line. They'll spot him back at the 13 where his knee first touched down.
One of the things that happened on a cold day defensively is you don't wrap up like you ordinarily would on a warm day to make the tackle. And on that particular play, a couple Nebraska defenders had a shot at Eric Bieniemy but didn't wrap up.
Gain of four for Bieniemy, second and six. Hagan in trouble and down. Mike Petko, the junior inside linebacker from Anaheim, California, threw him for a loss back to the 19.
Watch Mike Petko on the replay. The linebackers are deep, play deep for Nebraska. As soon as he sees the fullback move, he's coming up and he's responsible for the quarterback. He has the quarterback inside out. The outside backer has him outside. And that's what he wants to do, make the big play and get this crowd fired up. Watch a quarterback draw right here, some type of draw.
Third down and 11. Tremendous noise from a sellout crowd of 76,000. The enemy right up the middle. Down to the five with a first down for Colorado.
We can see Colorado's plan right here in the first half is just to run right at Nebraska. I believe on this play, Mike Petko overran it. Again, a good block by George Hemingway, the fullback. They're taking big splits with the offensive line and trying to run inside.
Eric Bieniemy, Colorado's all-time leading rusher, all-time leader in 100-yard games, all-time leading scorer. And he's adding to those figures on this opening drive for the Buffaloes. They spotted him down at the six, first and goal. The option, Hagan.
Ball carried by Hagan.
Down close to the 2-yard line.
Colorado, when Bill McCartney took over, was a pro passing team. Then they moved to the wishbone offense. Now they're to Nebraska's power offense. And where they put a lot of pressure on the defense, both Colorado and Nebraska, is when you get on the 3-yard line or 4-yard line like they are right now, you can't go to a goal line defense because of the option. The option is so much of a threat down here in the short yardage situation.
The enemy lost the football. No word yet from the officials on the recovery. The Huskers think they have it. The one rap against Eric Bieniemy is that he sometimes coughs up the football in key situations. This time, the Buffaloes got it back.
Well, there's a lot of, when you're in a pile like that, there's a lot of pulling on the football, but you always teach your defensive people, point like you have the football. You may be able to affect the official. Here you see Bieniemy and the ball coming loose right here. Tyrone Bird made the hit. Of course, then it becomes a pulling party underneath.
Third and goal from the two.
I would expect some type of option here with Darian Hagan being the main ball carrier in this situation.
Bieniemy stopped short of the goal line. Travis Hill made the hit, and Nebraska has held.
He fumbled the football.
And they came up with it, did the Cornhuskers. Bieniemy loses it on two consecutive plays. Hill knocked it free, and Nebraska takes over first and 10.
That's a big play right here, Sean. Two times in a row, Eric Bieniemy dropped the football. Two good hits by the Nebraska defense. It's a cold day, so sometimes you have a little bit of a tough time holding on to the football. But again, Travis Hill made the hit in the backfield. They brought him from the outside backer spot.
Hill knocked it loose and Tahan Lewis recovered it. Nebraska on first down, just trying to get some room.
Just an isolation play up the inside. Now Tom Osborne and Nebraska coach is thinking a couple first downs, be able to get out from being back in my own goal line and punt the football. You can see the turnover ratio here in Nebraska, 31 takeaways, 16 giveaways. That's how you win a lot of football games.
Gain of two on first down. Now the option for Joseph. Leotis Flowers has running room. Has a first down out to the 16-yard line. Tim James made the tackle for Colorado.
Even though it's a wet day and it's a cold day, Nebraska's going to do what they do best. That's the option. Watch Mickey Joseph here, but watch the fullback, Lance Lewis, go up and make a big play, get the ball pitched out to Leotis Flowers and pick up a key first down.
.10 to play in the first quarter, no score. Colorado squandered a great opportunity to score with the win at its back here in the first quarter when Bieniemy fumbled on third and goal at the two. Lance Lewis out to the 20-yard line, a pickup of four for the sophomore from Scott City, Kansas.
This is going to be a field position football game. I don't think you're going to see a lot of passes, especially out of Nebraska, going into the win right now. Tackle-to-tackle football game with the option being the big play for Mickey Joseph.
The option again. Joseph trying to turn the corner and cannot. Alfred Williams, the man who forced Mickey Joseph to seek the cover of the sideline, a loss on the play. Back to the 19.
Well, the one thing Nebraska has to do on the option play, Colorado effectively made them string it out. If you can put indecision in the mind of the quarterback, that's the thing you need to do to stop the option. Both Mickey Joseph and Darian Hagan are from warm weather climates. Mickey Joseph from Louisiana, Darian Hagan from California. But they've adapted well. And we'll play this game in the cold weather day that we have today.
It is snowing in other parts of the state of Nebraska. It is possible it will be snowing here before this game is over. Joseph sacked back inside the 15-yard line. Gary Howe with the sack for Colorado, the senior from Spencer, Iowa, with his eighth sack of the year.
Well, Mickey Joseph went back to set up the pass. Nothing was open, and he was going to take off real quick. He is a good scrambler. Both he and Darian Hagan, you have to have controlled rushes against them, because if you go in and you lose the leverage, they'll take off and make big plays against you.
Mike Stigge, his first punt into the wind, traveled 26 yards. Colorado should again get great field position. McLuhan let the ball bounce, and that's a mistake. It takes a big Nebraska roll. The Huskers trying to earn some extra yardage by batting the ball further downfield. The officials will spot it at the 33. No score. We're in the first quarter.
Most people don't think about high efficiency till it's too late. But if your home doesn't have an efficient Heil furnace, you could be throwing money right up the chimney. A Heil furnace keeps you warm without freezing the rest of your budget. Heil Home Heating Systems, the energy savers.
It's not just a car, it's your freedom.
We'll do it in 29 minutes or less, or the next one's free.
I'll tell you, most people are flabbergasted we do it so fast.
Mr. Goodwrench, Quick Lube Plus takes longer to say it than it does to do it.
We use AC filters and GM Goodwrench oil. It's what your owner's manual recommends.
And you know it also includes a 10-point maintenance check, too.
See Mr. Goodwrench wherever you see these signs.
We're going head-to-head on price, too.
Whether I'm racing 200 miles an hour or driving 55, I don't accept compromises. You shouldn't either. Cars should be responsive, yet fuel efficient. Roomy, yet sleek. not to mention affordable.
Well, surprisingly, one car does all that and more. The new Cutlass Supreme.
And in the coming months, we'll show you, when you take a look at any new Cutlass Supreme, you'll see.
Here's one car that does it all and does it right.
New generation of old.
ESPN's presentation of CFA football, Colorado versus Nebraska, is being brought to you by Oldsmobile. Stop by your Oldsmobile dealer and see what's new from the new generation of Olds. And by Mr. Goodwrench, the GM service expert at your participating GM dealers. No score in the first quarter. Sean McDonough with Mike Gottfried and Kevin Guthrie. The winner of this game will in all likelihood win the Big 8 title. The winner of this game would go to 5-0 with two games remaining on the Big 8 schedule. Darian Hagan, following the 53-yard punt by Stiggy, goes to play action on first and 10. Looking deep, throwing deep, and has a man open! And the ball is dropped. Mike Pritchard was in the clear, and he could not make the catch. Here's Tim Brandel.
Fellas, the winning coach in this game in the Big Ten could likely be Big Ten Coach of the Year, but watch the ball fake by Matt Rogers. Totally fools everyone with the pass. It's to Nick Bell, and Bell tiptoes down the sidelines. The mighty Hawkeyes have a 21-0 lead. The game is still in the second quarter. Let's get back to Sean.
A lot of bad blood between those two schools.
Sean, they're going to try to use the wind a little bit while they have it. That's why they tried to throw the deep route there. Mike Pritchard was right on the money. Just when he hit the ground, he dropped the football.
The enemy has fumbled twice already, lost one. Colorado recovered the other. The enemy got out to the 36 for a gain of 3. Third down and 7 upcoming. Bill McCartney told us last night that he felt the wind and the rain would hurt Colorado more than it would hurt Nebraska, because Colorado came to Lincoln hoping to throw the football perhaps as many as 25 times. Well, that's going to be hard to do today. On third and 7, Walker takes down Darian Hagan from behind. His 10th quarterback sack of the year.
Kenny Walker is very quick. When Ariel Solomon trying to set up to pass block him, he came inside. He's just too quick for Ariel Solomon.
Now Tom ruined the punt with the wind at his back. Uncharacteristically, he had two shanks last week against Oklahoma. Bobbled the snap but had time as Nebraska was not rushing all out. Tyrone Hughes. Down at the 26-yard line. Nebraska goes back on offense with 4:52 left in the first quarter. No score.
Presents George Strait.
Buying a new car is a big step. With many car makers, the minute you drive it out the door, you may feel like you're on your own. But at Oldsmobile, you're covered by the Oldsmobile Edge, the most comprehensive owner satisfaction program in the industry. Standard on every new Oldsmobile. We're with you every step of the way.
The popularity of GM's good-looking, hard-working trucks raises the issue of keeping up with the Joneses. That's why your GM dealer offers a variety of accessories to personalize your new or used GM truck. They work right, fit right, and look right, because they're from General Motors. Get them wherever you see these signs. Now, about the Joneses. Don't say we didn't warn you.
The sack by Kenny Walker of Nebraska forced Colorado to punt. Walker has been deaf since the age of two. With more on that story down on the sideline, here's Kevin.
Kenny Walker, the way he gets his information is this extraordinary woman, his sign language interpreter, Mimi Mann. Mimi, tell us a little bit about how you help Kenny.
Well, I go with Kenny into many different areas of his life. I'm in the classroom with him. I go into his meetings. I go onto the field if he needs me, and most everything he does with football, I'm there if he requests.
5 years ago, when you came into this, you knew nothing about football. 5 years later now, tell us, has it become more than just a job for you?
It's more than a job. Now it's an honor.
It's an honor. And it's also Kenny's last game. He's a senior. His last game here in Lincoln, that is. It's your last game, too. How do you feel?
I feel that a person can't have any more emotions stuffed into one body than I have right now. My heart feels very full.
Thank you, Mimi. Sean, back to you.
Gain of three on the first play for Flowers. Here's Leotis again. For a gain of two. Here's Tim.
Sean, Georgia Tech's back in it. After Virginia had fumbled on their opening drive of the third quarter, Sean Jones goes to Jerry Gilchrist on the reverse. It's a TD to make it a 28-21 game. The Ramblin' Wreck back in it. Meanwhile, Hayden's Hawkeyes have taken a 28-0 lead in the second quarter of that game in the run for the Roses. Back to Sean, Mike, and Kevin.
First game. Nebraska wins this ball game. If Virginia should stumble, would move to number one.
Leotis Flowers did not appear to pick up the first down. Needed to reach the 36, got only to the 35 before he was tackled by Gary Howe.
Sean, one thing you see on the field, the middle of the field is a little drier right now, so you get a little bit better footing in between the hashes. Outside of the hashes, you can see where it's wet, so you have a hard time cutting. So I expect that they'll try to keep the run game more in the middle of the football field.
They're going to measure, but from our vantage point, it looks like Nebraska is almost a full yard short of a first down. And indeed, the Huskers are well short.
This will be an interesting decision right here. I think he probably would punt, but when you've got a half yard there and the wind is such a factor, he's got 3:25, Tom Osborne does, on the clock yet till he reverses this wind problem that he has.
He does have the punting unit on the field, and again, Dave McLuhan is back deep for Colorado. Stiggy's last punt, 53 yards, matching his career long. You wouldn't have thought that was possible under the wind he's kicking into. But he's had plenty of help from the roll on the last two punts.
That's the best kind of punch you can have into the wind. A low punt, keep it away from him, and get the bounce.
And despite going into the stiff breeze in the first quarter, Nebraska is winning the battle of field position. 3 minutes to play and a scoreless first quarter.
From personal to advanced full color, America's most popular copier is Canon. Don Barr Incorporated is your authorized Canon dealer.
We've had Don Barr equipment for over 6 years, and their quality and service is excellent. Thanks, Don Barr.
Don Barr Incorporated, quality and service in office products.
When I was elected Secretary of State, many of you told me government costs too much. I agreed with you, so I did something about it. We modernized our office by computerization. Now we're so efficient that we take in more money than we spend, $17 million more. That's right. In the last 8 years, my office has made a net profit for Ohio of $17 million. If you reelect me, I will do even better. And you can take that to the bank, too.
Reelect Secretary of State Sherrod Brown.
ESPN brings you coast-to-coast NCAA basketball. The action's outstanding. Everywhere you look, there's down-to-the-wire excitement.
Unbelievable! Unbelievable! Awesome, baby! Sensational! Super!
A new season tips off when top teams battle in the Dodge NIT. Tournament action begins Wednesday, November 14th at 7:30 Eastern, live on ESPN.
175th straight sellout here at Memorial Stadium in Lincoln. That streak dates back to 1962. And it's the longest current home sellout streak in college football. Colorado on first down, Bieniemy. A good run to get out close to the 20. They'll spot him down near the 18. A gain of three.
Watch the play here where Darren Hagan goes back deep and gives the ball to Eric Bieniemy. He gives it to him deep so that he is laterally right next to him or behind him so that Eric Bieniemy has a lot of room to look over the offensive line and to cut back.
Bieniemy again, knocked down behind the line of scrimmage. Leandre Anderson back up, left defensive tackle, got just a piece of Bieniemy to trip him up.
One thing about Nebraska is they'll play a lot of players. They have 180 players on scholarship. You see Leandre Anderson come through and make the play. The benefit of having a lot of football players like they do is that you get a great look in practice. Your scout team is some of the best high school players in the country. So consequently, when you practice against them, you get the best look. Possible quarterback draw here, or some type of draw.
Hagan got it off. It's incomplete, intended for Bieniemy. Kenny Walker hit Hagan just as he let go of it.
What Colorado was going to go to instead of the draw was a screen, but watch Kenny Walker. He's just too quick, not blocked at all here, and was able to put pressure on Darren Hagan. They practiced against him yesterday, Bill McCartney said, by putting the fastest scout team player he could over there and telling him the starting count. It obviously helped, but they're going to have to really contend with him all day.
Tom Ruin, the consensus All-American punter last year when he led the nation, averaging nearly 46 yards per punt. He hasn't been quite as strong this year. Under a strong rush, his is a wobbly kick that goes out of bounds at the 41-yard line of Colorado. Just a 25-yard kick with a 25-mile-per-hour wind at his back for Tom Ruin.
Well, Tom Ruin's one of the biggest, best punters in the Big 8 and in the country. But when you punt in the Big 8, you're going to have days like this. And you've got to be able to punt the ball, as I said earlier, a little bit lower and get the bounce.
With a minute 41 left in a scoreless first quarter, it's first and 10, Nebraska. The Cornhuskers working with their best field position at the Colorado 41. Flowers dropped for a loss. First man to hit him, Greg Binkert, the inside linebacker, sophomore from Longmont, Colorado.
So much movement by Colorado on the defensive line. The linebackers Greg Binkert and Terry Johnson are going to be free just like they were on that particular play. Mickey Joseph's going to have to play action or run the option against the Colorado defense. They may open it up a little bit now because the field position's changed. They have 1 minute, 12 seconds to go till they get the win.
Loss of two on first down. Flowers still on his feet. He's down at the 37-yard line.
Both teams mirror offenses. Watch Lance Lewis, the fullback, blocking on the linebacker. Good block on Terry Johnson, opened it up for Leotis Flowers. There was a little seam to the outside there that Leotis Flowers didn't see. Again, as you see the time, it's going to be a drastic change in field position here for Nebraska. This is the first chance they've had to really work.
The option. With the blitz on for Colorado, Joseph tripped up short of the first down. Tim James came up from his safety spot to make the tackle.
Colorado's going to call timeout, Sean, because they don't want the clock to run out so that Nebraska would have the win to kick a field goal. So they're going to make them force them on fourth down now to make a decision whether to punt the football or to try to run the play on fourth down. A good call by Bill McCartney, very alert because he's not going to give them the win just yet.
This is game two of today's triple header of college football on ESPN tonight at 7:30 Eastern time. Number 4 Auburn meets number 15 Florida from Florida Field in Gainesville. The Tigers are 10th nationally in total defense And a single loss could eliminate Auburn from the national title chase. Certainly they're very much in it, but they've had some narrow escapes this season against some lightly regarded opponents.
Well, they really have. They've played well enough to win, which is a credit to their football team and Pat Nye. They'll have a tough test tonight against Florida. But again, the national picture will clear up just a little bit today as these two games, the Virginia game finishes and Nebraska and Colorado finishes. I think both these teams, Nebraska and Colorado, still have a chance for the national title. I wouldn't be a bit surprised they go for it here. I mean, it's a fourth down situation, so the field position, if they punted the football, they might punt them into the hole. But yet, look for an option here on Mickey Joseph.
You saw Tom Osborne's record against Colorado, 15-2. He has never lost to the Buffaloes here in Lincoln. 8-0 at Memorial Stadium. Indeed, Nebraska is going for it on fourth down. Joseph, the pitch to Flowers. He has the first down. Had some running room if he could have stayed in bounds. He goes out of bounds at the 25-yard line with a first down for Nebraska.
Where Nebraska does a good job here. Mickey Joseph, watch the fake to the fullback. Again, he'll become a blocker now. Comes Mickey Joseph out. He pitches the ball to Leotis Flowers and gets a good block by Nate Turner on the outside. If it wasn't, again, wet on the side like that from hash to hash, Leotis Flowers would have been able to cut and maybe take that all the way.
Flowers came into today's game averaging 7 yards per rush, tied for the national lead in that category with Randy Baldwin of Mississippi. 12 seconds left in a scoreless first quarter. Flowers. Knocked down by Greg Thomas, but not before he picked up 6 more on the final play of the first quarter. Tom Osborne and the Huskers moving into a stiff wind in the first quarter. They survived the fumble by Bieniemy, dodged that big bullet, and now they're on the move.
Oh, no problem. Keep the meeting as scheduled.
Your car is too important to have it tied up all day. I know. I'm Mr. Goodwrench. And this is Mr. Goodwrench Quick Lube Plus. Right here in your GM dealership. Quick Lube Plus, we guarantee a complete lube and oil change with AC filters and GM Goodwrench oil in 29 minutes or less. So the next one's free. So you can drive in knowing your car will be done fast.
It's ready. I'm on my way.
Drive out knowing it's done right.
Mr. Goodwrench knows it's not just a car, it's a freedom.
This is how the roomy new Cutlass Supreme SL looks after traveling 300 highway miles on just 10 gallons of gas. And this is how Honda Accord looks after the same challenge. Well, if it hadn't run out of gas 20 miles back, you'd see that it's smaller and it's blue. And next trip, Dad, it's yours. Who says you can't get great gas mileage in a roomy, comfortable car? Cutlass Supreme is one car that does it all and does it right.
This is the new generation of old.
Heating your house efficiently can be a tough job. Learn how to do it with the facts about energy-efficient furnaces and heat pumps. It's all in the Heil Home Comfort Guide, free when you call this number. Learn how systems work, about efficiency ratings, about units from the inside out. Call Heil for your free copy of the Home Comfort Guide. Heil Home Heating Systems, the energy savers.
A6, hurry and you'll make it.
Delta Airlines ticket agent Sam Singletary knows how to get people moving.
Mr. Franklin, you're back.
But sometimes he has to show off a few moves of his own. The kind of moves that made him a first-string halfback. Sam Singletary shares a feeling with everyone at Delta. He loves what he's doing. And it shows.
We love to fly.
He's the kid.
And it shows.
I remember my first weekend away. I saved for half the summer, but hey, it was my money, and it still is.
Thrifty.
So to get away today, I rent from Thrifty.
Thrifty.
At Thrifty Car Rental, a Chrysler Fifth Avenue safety equipped with an airbag is just $39.95 a day. Like my grandma always said, if you know where you're going, you better know how to get there.
Thrifty.
Thrifty. Because it's your money.
Thrifty.
Mike, from this shot, we can see the middle of the field where it's crowned so much more dry than the perimeter of the field. Does that affect the play calling?
Well, it doesn't really affect the play calling, but it affects the cutting of the tailbacks and the quarterback when you're inside that hash.
on second and four for Nebraska. Leotis Flowers close to a first down at the 15. No score as we start the second quarter, but Nebraska is on the move.
Not a lot of people are for turf, and I'd like to play on grass when I was coaching and playing, but the one benefit when you have a bad day like this, the field does dry as it goes along, but the middle of the field is where most of the running and cutting will occur.
The Cornhuskers just short of a first down, third down, less than a yard. Joseph picks it up himself. Needed to get to the 15. He moved the football to the 14. First down, Nebraska.
You see Tom Osborne sending the plays, and in between series, he'll be given the cards of the blocking schemes that Nebraska's run and the adjustments that Colorado's making. He's an on-the-field coach. He's doing the play calling. He does a lot of the game planning and makes a lot of the play calls.
On first down, this time Nebraska tried the fullback, and the fullback hopes that they won't try that again as Lance Lewis was clotheslined right at the line of scrimmage.
Watch again Colorado defensively. Watch the lineman move. Watch this defensive lineman, Brian Diet, come down and make the play on the fullback. Again, as I said in the opening, the movement of the Colorado defensive front will really affect the offensive line of Nebraska. Now, again, I think you got to look for Mickey Joseph in the option.
And here comes Mickey. Looks like he wants to keep it himself. He's out of bounds near the 13-yard line. Chased out by Tim James.
Colorado's doing a good job when Mickey Joseph does scramble of keeping good leverage and making him work the field and not letting him cut up the football field. Last year in this ballgame, Darren Hagan on the Colorado side made a lot of big plays going back to pass, nothing open, and then taking off with it. Both quarterbacks are very effective that way.
Third down and nine. Normally a passing down, but Nebraska is not a passing team.
I look for something over the middle to maybe the wing back over here in this formation.
Joseph runs away from the rush. Short of the first down, he's out of bounds. He crossed the nine, and that was all needed to reach the four. He's a good 5 yards short of the first down. Dion Figures, the cornerback, chased him out.
As we said, both quarterbacks have that scrambling ability. Here you got a crisscross stunt on the outside where Colorado comes free. Mickey Joseph sees it, takes off, but can't pick up the first down. Now brings on the field goal kicker, and something now, he needs his footing. He's on the side, on the hash side here, so he's got to be very sure of his steps on the wet turf.
And because he's left-footed, he's starting where the turf is a bit more wet. From 26 yards, Greg Barrios drives it through. And Nebraska is first on the board. It's 3-0 Cornhuskers.
A new high-output 4-liter engine. Anti-lock brakes. And exclusive shift-on-the-fly, full-time 4-wheel drive. Make Jeep Cherokee the ultimate vehicle for the hustle and bustle of everyday life.
Save up to $2,500 on 1990 Cherokees or get 50th anniversary discounts on select 91s.
Hojo.
ESPN's presentation of CFA football, Colorado versus Nebraska, is being brought to you by Jeep. There's only one Jeep. And by Campbell's Chunky Soup, the satisfying stop that keeps you going. With a little chunky soup, tastes good right now. A cold, raw day in Lincoln, Nebraska. The Cornhuskers, after a 26-yard field goal by Greg Barrios, lead 3-0. Myron Bennett with the kickoff. Mike Pritchard with the return, knocked down at the 15-yard line. Dan Spahela, a backup linebacker, made the play on special teams.
On the run back, here you see Pritchard and the hit being made. A lot of times Nebraska, when I said earlier, they have 180 players on this football team. They'll play a lot of players that won't even travel to away games on the kickoff team.
First and 10, Colorado from its own 16. Dangerous pitch. Bieniemy, gain of perhaps one, and that's all. Kenny Walker wrapped him up. Pat Tyrance was there as well. Here's Tim.
The Lonesome Boys from Laramie having problems with Colorado State in the WAC. And remember, the Cowboys 9-0 on the season coming in. This is Todd Gurrett of the Rams. Coach Earl Bruce's club trying to pull off the victory that would send the wild, wild WAC into an even wackier mode. Back to Sean.
Wyoming with a big game next week against BYU. No gain on first down. Here's Bieniemy again, this time with blockers. He slips down as the tacklers closed in at the 21. Tyrance again in on the tackle with Tyrone Leggett.
Well, both linebackers are making him pitch the football so that the corners and the strong safety and free safety have to make the play on the pitch. Force him in this third and five against the wind. I still, Bill McCartney probably will throw. He's got the draw possibilities.
Third and five, Colorado. Hagan under pressure. Throws, intercepted. Mike Petko picks it off for Nebraska.
Darren Hagan sets up back here to throw. In a one-back offense, he's got the tight end over the middle open and on the move. Very difficult to get anything on that football. And Mike Petko steps in front and makes the interception. Again, turns the field position around, Sean.
First interception of the year for Petko, just the second of his career. The pitch dropped, but fortunately for Nebraska, it went out of bounds. Scott Baldwin, the backup I-back, couldn't handle the pitch from Joseph, but it bounced off Baldwin and went out of bounds.
Turnovers in a day like today will play such a big factor. You have Nebraska so far in this football game has been able to play the wind and been able to use it to their advantage. Even though they're only hit 3-0, they completely dominated the football game with the wind in mind. Colorado, of course, blew an opportunity early to get on the board.
A loss of one on first down for Nebraska. Joseph, incomplete. Throwing behind his intended target, the tight end, Johnny Mitchell. Good coverage by Thomas. Down to the sidelines, here's Kevin.
I tell you what, on the sideline, on the field, very slippery. What happens is you get these puddles. Wet turf isn't bad, but when you get the puddles, it's almost like a car tire hydroplaning on the road. Guys go to push off, it splashes, their feet slide out. Also, a guy like Bieniemy on Colorado's offense, he gets on the side of his foot, he loses his footing. Back to you, Sean.
And Kevin had to battle those elements from time to time during his career as a standout wide receiver at Princeton. Joseph trying to scramble for the first down, and he's knocked out short of the first down. Deion Figures came up from his cornerback spot to drive Joseph out of bounds at the 26. A good 2.5 yards short of a first down. Decision time for Tom Osborne, but it looks like the field goal unit is coming on with the wind at their backs.
3 points is going to be very important here. Talked to Jerry Johnson yesterday, the Converse representative. He's here. Nebraska wears Converse shoes, and on a dry day they'll wear a shoe that's a flat bottom shoe with a little nub on the bottom, but on a wet day like this it's a little bit bigger, and I think Kevin can show that to us a little bit later.
Greg Barrios has already connected from 26. This one, a 44-yard try, it would be his longest of the year. It has the distance, and it's right down Broadway. First field goal from beyond 40 yards this year for Barrios. Couple of field goals, and it's 6-0 Nebraska.
Hojo.
Recently, Four Wheel and Off-Road magazine took this year's 4x4 of the Year winner and all the past winners and conducted a head-to-head showdown to determine the best of the best. So who won? Who do you think? There are a lot of 4x4s out there, but there's only one Jeep.
Save up to $2,500 on 1990 Cherokees or get 50th anniversary discounts on select 91.
Like a lot of business people, I thought all insurance companies were the same. Believe me, there's a world of difference out there. I know, because thanks to the Hartford, we survived the kind of fire that would have wiped out most companies. But with the Hartford's people behind my business, we met payroll. We got back on our feet. So please, don't tell me all insurance companies are the same. They're not.
ITT Hartford, when you need us most, we're at our best.
Nebraska has a 6-0 lead with 11:25 left to play in the first half. Today's ITT Hartford student athlete of the game is Nebraska's number 40, senior linebacker Pat Tyrance. He carries a 3.7 grade point average in pre-med. Pat's from Omaha. He received a National Football Foundation $10,000 scholarship this past week, one of 11 players so honored. Congratulations to Pat Tyrance. He's also married, has an infant son. He's thinking about med school. Byron Bennett, the kickoff. It bounces up. And in trouble is Dwayne Davis. He's down at the 11-yard line. Not a very long scoring drive for the second field goal for Nebraska. It took just 24 seconds. Three plays and 8 yards accumulated by the Cornhuskers, and Barrios converted his second field goal of the game.
We seem to bring the field goals out in everybody.
Indeed we do. In our last two telecasts coming into today, we have not seen a touchdown. 9-0 last week on three field goals, and 9-6 on five field goals 2 weeks ago. Bieniemy with a hole up the middle and a quality gain on first down as he's out to the 19, a gain of 8. Here's Tim.
Sean, Georgia Tech had just tied the game on a touchdown pass to Emmett Merchant, but look at this. Fake double reverse. Sean Moore. Need I say more? Herman, touchdown. Two passes from those two to lead to Sean Moore touchdowns, a two-point conversion, and now a touchdown for the Moore brothers.
He's a great football player. The Moore to Moore combination.
On second and two, Bieniemy picks up the first down. First and 10, Colorado, as Bieniemy moves the Buffaloes to the 25.
Talking to Bill McCartney and Mike Berry, the offensive line coach, last night, it felt like that they felt that they could come in and run the football from tackle to tackle. They've had some success here early on the isolation play. Nebraska has been successful stopping the outside plays. They've had some success with Bieniemy, and of course the fumbles hurt early.
If you're just tuning in, Eric Bieniemy fumbled as Colorado was driving down the field. He fumbled at the Nebraska 2. Since then, Nebraska has picked two field goals. Hagan has a man. Pritchard can't hang on. The pass was a bit behind him. Well, that's the second time Hagan has hit the hands of Pritchard without Mike catching it today.
Mike Pritchard, the wide receiver from Las Vegas, Nevada. Here's the fake to Bieniemy.
Again, Darian Hagan was looking for the tight end. Here's where he becomes dangerous once he gets outside. Nebraska does a good job. Here's the ball thrown to Mike Pritchard, a little bit behind him, but in a cold weather day, it's a little tough to make that catch. Bruce Pickens on the coverage for Nebraska. Darian Hagan, he's a seasoned veteran. He's not going to get down. He knows he's a touchdown away from taking the lead.
The enemy, a yard to the 26.
Tom Osborne's had a lot of great football teams here in Nebraska, and he talked about his defense. He said this may be his best defense. And what makes it the best is they all can run. They have great team speed. They're very quick. They get off blocks very well, and their secondary has been very effective for them. So defensively, their statistics are mind-boggling. People question their schedule, but hey, they've been able to stop everybody they played defensively.
Third and nine. Hagan wrapped up and thrown down by Kenny Walker. That is a clap that you just saw for Kenny Language and Kenny Walker, rather, inside Language. The palms outstretched over your head with the wrist rotating is a clap, and there was a silent clap for Kenny as he took the field before the game.
Well, as you see here again, Sean, Kenny Walker just too fast for Ariel Solomon. The one thing Colorado doesn't want to get into is third and longs, because that makes Kenny Walker very dangerous on the pass rush.
Ruin punting into the wind now. It rolls a couple of yards for the Buffaloes. And it will be spotted at the 46. This year's game, as Bill McCartney said earlier, absolutely critical, as was last year's matchup between these two teams. 1989, number 3 Nebraska versus number 2 Colorado, the decisive game for the Big 8 championship. Nebraska trailing by 6 as Jerry Godowski goes for it all on the final play. But Dave McLuhan breaks it up, and Colorado gains its first outright Big 8 title in 28 years. And the Buffaloes shooting for back-to-back Big 8 crowns. They need to win this football game. They trail 6-0, and Nebraska has it back. Play action on first down. And the pass nearly intercepted. Deion Figures got his hands on it. Nate Turner was wide open, running over the middle of the football field, but Joseph decided not to go to Turner. Instead, he was going for Mitchell. And it was incomplete.
Play action fake by Mickey Joseph. He's got Nate Turner up the middle of the field open, but he's going to throw back, and it's covered very well. A good call by Tom Osborne. You got the win, first down, you're running the ball very well. Get them off of you. Throw the ball deep and make their defense, even if you don't complete the pass, know that you're going to be able to go up on top.
Joseph threw 4 times last week against Iowa State, but completed all 4, 2 of them for touchdowns. Cornhuskers rushed for 557 yards last week. A fumble. Joseph couldn't recover it. It's still free, and the Buffaloes get it back.
Big play right here.
Brian Dyett, the recovery, Mike.
Big play for the Colorado defense. One thing about both these teams, they both understand the option, so defending it is a little bit easier. Here's the option by Mickey Joseph. Again, they understand the option, so they're feathering. See number 94 right there, Alfred Williams? He makes him pitch the football. Now there's the big hit. Colorado almost made a mistake by trying to pick it up and running with the football rather than just recovering it.
Brian McLuhan knocked it free. Brian Dyett, who's a backup tackle, recovered it. Dyett's seen a lot of action here today, and he's made a couple of big plays. Great balance by Bieniemy on first down as he kept his footing and moved forward for 5 yards to the 35.
Again, Kenny Walker came free on the inside, almost wrapped up Eric Bieniemy in the backfield. Good job by Eric of keeping his feet, breaking outside.
We're approaching the midway mark of the second quarter. Nebraska leads 6-0 on a pair of Greg Barrios field goals. Look out, Bieniemy loses the football. Hagan recovers it back in Colorado territory. They'll spot him at the 44-yard line.
T. tell you, both these defensive teams are giving you a clinic on how to stop the option. Here comes Darian Hagan. They force the pitch and then get somebody, Tyrone Byrd, up into the face of the pitch man to cause the fumble. A big play by the Nebraska defense because they pushed him back again inside the 50-yard line.
That is a 21-yard loss for Colorado. Third and 26, back at the 44 of the Buffaloes. Hagan throwing it into the wind. Incomplete. Intended for Rico Smith. Bruce Pickens knocked it down. Here's Tim Brendel.
Another one of the unbeatens could be going down, Sean. Wyoming driving. Carranza's hands off to Jay Depper, but there's a fumble! And it's recovered by Harlan Carroll. But what happened? Colorado State fumbled. Wyoming's got it back with 2 minutes left, trying to go to 10-0.
Timmy's giving it. Is that fumble or how is it?
I think that's a little bit of Keith Jackson. And pretty well done. A punt for Ruin. Manages to hang it up in that wind. Fair catch made by Turner. Nebraska takes over at its own 19, leading 6-0.
Over 33 years, Joyce Buick has built a reputation for excellent service and quality cars at affordable prices. And now we would like to announce a new and exciting improvement. We've added Joyce Mitsubishi with the all-new Mitsubishi line to our dealership. Come in and look over America's fastest-growing car line. Joyce Mitsubishi, where the one thing will never change is our commitment to you. Mitsubishi, the word is getting around.
Bob Olson just got a Centel cellular phone for his business. Before long, his phone was helping him handle more business. In fact, business got so good, Bob had to buy more Centel cellular phones to go with his new trucks.
Mike Singletary hits hard, but not like the hard-hitting football news on ESPN's Emmy Award-winning NFL Game Day. The team of Berman, Axtell, Jackson, Edelstein, and Deichmann hit the air each Sunday. Jerry Rice can cover the field, but not like the football coverage on ESPN's hour-long NFL Game Day. We'll take you all around the NFL and inside the numbers. NFL Game Day, Sundays at noon Eastern, only on ESPN.
Friends, you might have a tough time believing as you look at this shot of the heater along the Colorado sideline that it was in the mid-70s and a beautiful sunny day Thursday here in Lincoln. Today it's in the high 30s with a chance of snow. The rain has subsided at the moment. First and 10, Nebraska. Flowers knocked down at the line of scrimmage. Here's Kevin Guthrie.
Why are they fumbling? It's not just because it's wet. It's the combination of cold and wet which makes it raw. What happens is your hand holding the football, it gets cold. You lose feeling in your knuckles. You lose feeling in your fingers, and you lose the ball. The second thing, you're holding it close to your body. You got long sleeves on, and you don't have as good a feel for the ball. You get hit, you cough it up, and there's the fumble.
There's so much at stake in this football game. Nebraska and Colorado, if they win this football game, it could be still that they'd have a great shot to the national title.
Omar Soto, backup fullback, bulls his way out to the 27-yard line, about 2 yards short of a first down.
Nebraska runs the fullback so much in the offense as a blocker. Every now and then, they'll give him the football. Against Omar Soto, the backup fullback picks up good yardage. Puts him in a third down short situation.
Running backs coach Frank Solich of Nebraska compares Soto to Tom Rathman as a blocker, and that's the highest praise you can possibly give a fullback. This is Baldwin, the backup eye back, who picks up the first down. Here's Tim Brando.
Sean, I hate to keep interrupting, but there's just a heck of a lot going on. Take a look at the rambling wreck inside the eight. The pitch from Sean Jones to William Bell. And ring up a touchdown for the Engineers. The game is tied at 35 in the fourth quarter. I'll be talking to you again, Sean.
Somehow we thought you would be. What a great game. A lot of times the games that get the big build-up don't live up to those advanced expectations, but not so today in Charlottesville. Baldwin juggled the pitch momentarily, managed to take it in and make it a gain out to the 37-yard line. He picked up three on first down.
Nebraska's using a lot of the second-team backs at this particular point. Going to try to wear Colorado down, playing two different teams on both offense and defense. If that score holds up, the Virginia and Georgia Tech, there's no doubt if Nebraska wins, they'll go to number one.
Coming up at halftime, the Rayovac halftime report. Tim and Lee with scores and highlights from throughout the nation. Soto again. He redshirted last year after transferring in from Western Arizona Junior College. Omar's a junior from Miami. He didn't play last week against Iowa State because of a knee strain, but he's back in there today. They spot him down at the 40. That brings up third down and almost 4 yards to go for a Nebraska first down. The Cornhuskers leading 6-0. We're inside of 5 minutes to play in the second quarter. The option, Joseph thrown down to Nevis McGee. The All-American outside linebacker dropped him for a loss. They'll spot him at the 38-yard line.
It's a belly option again where Mickey Joseph fakes to the fullback. Fullback's going through as a blocker, but Canavis McGee gets right up in the face of Mickey Joseph before he can make the decision to pitch the football. A lot of times Nebraska will come up to the line of scrimmage with two different plays, one to one side, one to the other, and then check off according to the defensive front.
Stiggy to punt. You saw McLuhan waiting for it. With the wind, the line drive kick, McLuhan muffs it. Now he's in the end zone, he's in trouble. Down in the end zone, touchback. He never had possession of it in the field of play. And it is a touchback.
You see the ball kicked, it takes a bounce, it just breaks right out of the hands of Dave McLuhan. Finally gets hold of it in the end zone, and Nebraska commits to make the play. They'll start on the 20-yard line.
Tom Osborne requesting an explanation from this Big 8 officiating crew. It was a muff punt. He never did have possession of it, as you saw on the field of play, only picked it up in the end zone. Therefore, the touchback. Nothing doing for Darian Hagan on first down. He picked up a yard to the 21. McLuhan breathing a sigh of relief along the Colorado sideline. He's an outstanding punt returner. As we mentioned earlier, he's taken two back for touchdowns this year. His father, Kent, who is here today, played for Nebraska and also for the Oakland Raiders. He's now a scout for the Raiders. 6-0 Nebraska as we approach 3 minutes remaining in the first half. Bieniemy. Looked like he had some room outside. He bounced it inside and picked up two more to the 23. Third and 7 upcoming. These two of the top rushing offenses in the nation. Nebraska number 1 and Colorado number 7. Nebraska led the nation in rushing offense 6 times during the decade of the 1980s. Tough to get all those words out on a cold day like today. We're in an open-air hut on the roof at Memorial Stadium. On 3rd and 7, they go to the run, and Bieniemy got back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it.
The 3rd and long yardage, Bill McCartney now is playing the clock a little bit. He'd like to get in here at halftime if he can't get some kind of turnover and get a score, at least only be down 6-0, and then play the win in the 3rd and 4th quarter.
Now Nebraska has all 3 of its timeouts remaining. Should they have used one here with 2 minutes to play in the half?
No, I don't think so. I think you use it after they get the ball.
High snap. Ruin just did get the kickoff. Tyrone Hughes watched it bounce, and it's down to the 36. So Nebraska takes over with a minute 45 left in the first half. First and 10 at its own 36. The Huskers lead 6-0. Tomorrow, we invite you to join ESPN at noon Eastern. Get you ready for the big day of NFL action. It's game day. Then following all the day's action, it's NFL primetime at 7 Eastern time. The debut of ESPN's Sunday night NFL coverage. San Francisco and Dallas, Sunday, November 11th at 8 p.m. Eastern. Joseph throws incomplete. He was looking for Tyrone Hughes out of the backfield.
Most of Nebraska's passes are going to be play-action type passes. They're not a drop-back passing team, so it's going to come off the option. And on that particular play, there's just nothing open.
Second down, 10, at the 36.
Back to the run on second and 10. Baldwin. Tripped up by McLuhan after a gain of 8.
Third down, one.
Third and 2 upcoming. More into Colorado territory and down at the 42-yard line. Baldwin spelling Leotis Flowers. He's a sophomore from Roselle, New Jersey. And the Cornhuskers are back on the move with 52 seconds left.
Now Nebraska's got to think of using those timeouts. Here you see Baldwin stretching out the sweep play. Everybody stays on their block. He cuts it up. Now puts them in a situation that they've got to be able to move, use their timeouts, play their two-minute offense. The clock's running right now on them with 43 seconds to go to try to get a field goal. They've got to be a little quicker moving right here.
Joseph, forced out of the pocket, has running room. He's thrown down inbounds at the 35-yard line. Tim James made the tackle, and now the Cornhuskers use their first timeout. 6-0, Nebraska will return to Lincoln in just a moment.
You think you're bad, man? You think you're bad, man? This is bad. You know what I'm saying?
Hot the spicy chicken. So good, it's bad.
Say, hey, fellas, 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 fellas. Guess who's going out tonight?
He must be some pretty bad dude.
Not as bad as this chicken.
Hey, fellas, you don't know what you're talking about. This isn't bad. It's terrific.
Hot and spicy chicken.
Very good chicken.
This October at Kentucky Fried Chicken.
Roll with the clean, fresh taste of Bud Light. It won't fill you up, never let you down.
Hojo.
Sean McDonough with Mike Gottfried and Kevin Guthrie back at Memorial Stadium in Lincoln, Nebraska. The homestanding Cornhuskers looking for their 20th straight home victory. Lead Colorado 6-0, and Nebraska has the football at the Colorado 35-yard line. Looking at second down and 4 with 21 seconds left in the first half and with 2 timeouts remaining.
They're looking for a field goal right now. They're trying to get set up by 10 more yards to try to get a field goal to try to go in 9-0 at halftime.
Joseph slips down. Big loss. Now they're out of field goal range. Back to the 42-yard line, and Nebraska uses its second timeout with 14 seconds left.
That's a danger of setting up, dropping back, and throwing the football. He slipped right there. I think his shoe actually came off. But a bad decision. You got to try to throw the football and not take that sack. I don't think he really had a chance here. Once he went back to set up, he set up with his foot. Shoe came off. He went down. He really didn't have a chance to throw the ball and to ground it. Gary Howell put pressure on him.
And that's a soggy and cold foot that went back into that shoe.
They need to throw the ball about 10, 15 yards downfield here. Get that reception, get their timeout, try to tack that extra field goal on.
It'll be third down and 10. Running out of time, running out of the pocket, throws it away.
Intentional grounding.
Indeed it is. And here comes the flag. Well, no chance for a field goal now. 6 seconds left. And intentional grounding to call. It's a loss of down penalty.
This is the kind of play here, Sean, where you may just want to take the ball, go back, throw it, just throw it the length of the football field and see if something good can happen for you. With 6 seconds to go, I'm not sure you want to punt the football.
Really wouldn't be much sense in doing that, risking a bad snap or a block.
They'll either throw the ball down the field as far as they can or try to give it to the tailback and try to get something big just before the halftime, see if he can break it. And just go in 6-0.
Joseph throws, intercepted. Tim James has some blockers along the sideline. Now he's out of bounds at the 44. That's the final play of the half. It's the fifth interception of the season for Tim James. Two field goals for Greg Barrios of Nebraska in the first half, and at halftime, it's 6-0, Cornhuskers.
We're back at Memorial Stadium in Lincoln, Nebraska at halftime. Nebraska 6 and Colorado nothing. The Cornhuskers with two field goals by Greg Barrios in the first half. I'm Sean McDonough along with Mike Godfrey. We hope you're enjoying this football game. Not much offense on either side, as you might expect given the weather conditions.
Well, it's a tackle-to-tackle offensive approach in this half. When you look at the statistics, no yardage throwing the football. It's going to come down to turnovers and field position. You see the stats here, completions 0 for 5. Rushing yardage, 96 yards for Nebraska, 38 for Colorado. So it's a game of turnovers, a game of field position, and a game of field goals.
Colorado had the best chance to score early down to the sideline. Here's Kevin Guthrie.
I'm with Colorado head football coach Bill McCartney. Coach, your thoughts, down 6-0, you went in at halftime.
Well, we squandered the opportunity early when we were down in there, and we haven't handled the kicking game well at all. Every bounce in the kicking game virtually has gone against us, and we haven't been aggressive and smart in fielding kicks. That's hurt us field position-wise. We came in the game wanting to throw the ball more. We've got another quarter into the win. We'll try to throw it smart. In the third quarter and in the fourth quarter, we're going to air it out if we're behind.
Okay, thanks a lot, Coach. Good luck.
Thank you, Kevin. 6-0 Nebraska. Colorado will get the football first in the second half. Pritchett and Davis back deep to receive the opening kickoff. Byron Bennett, the freshman, will do the kicking. With the 25-mile-per-hour breeze at his back.
Nebraska's got to try to make some hay in this quarter with a win. Colorado would like to just be able to get some field position, Sean, so that they can try to make something happen this quarter, knowing full well the fourth quarter they're going to have the win.
Dwayne Davis lost the football. Again, a muff. He's entitled to down it in the end zone, and he does. Colorado gets it first and 10 at its own 20-yard line. The Buffaloes, no stranger to being behind at the half. They trailed Stanford in Boulder, 14-0 in intermission, went on to win that football game. They also trailed Washington and Oklahoma and came back to win those two football games. But Nebraska is a tough team to come back against. They've outscored their opponents in the second half, 194-22. And Bill McCartney, the Colorado coach, says of all the impressive statistics of Nebraska, he thinks that is the most impressive. Up the middle, the fullback, George Hemingway, picks up 14 on the first play from scrimmage of the second half.
A belly play for Colorado here. Darren Hagan takes the handoff, gets the ball to George Hemingway, and he cuts it back. The nose guard for Nebraska, Pat Engelbert, worked the front side, which opened that play up on the backside for George Hemingway. Colorado probably trying to keep the ball, run the ball inside against the Nebraska defense. That's what they had the most success doing.
That was the longest play from scrimmage for Colorado in this game, the 14-yard pickup. Here's Bieniemy with another quality gain to the 41. Seven more for the Buffalo.
First few minutes of the second half are important to try to set the momentum stage. Here you see Eric Bieniemy, the football, follow the block of George Hemingway into Pat Tyrants and good yardage. Both these first two plays now, they've done a pretty good job of blowing that defensive line off the ball for Nebraska.
Second down, 3 yards to go for a Colorado first down. The enemy has only been held under 100 yards once this season. That was by Texas. He fumbles the football, and Nebraska recovers. Travis Hill came up with the fumble, first and 10 Cornhuskers at the 45 of Colorado.
In this game, when you have a weather game like this, it becomes turnovers, becomes such a factor. Another fumble by Eric Bieniemy. Nebraska recovers it. Colorado had some momentum. Watch again, Eric Bieniemy working inside. You see the ball pop out before he gets down, recovered by Travis Hill right in the air.
And had he not run into his own man, Joe Sims, he would have been able to run with that football. Third time Bieniemy has put it on the ground. The second time the Buffaloes have lost the fumble. Joseph trying to make it hurt. Mickey Joseph down the sideline, out of bounds. Out of bounds at the 9-yard line. The Cornhuskers celebrate, but it is not a touchdown.
Nebraska, for one of the few times today, went to an unbalanced line, brought the wing back in motion, so they were a man ahead of Colorado on this side. You see Mickey Joseph, after he runs the option, breaks to the outside and is able to pick up some key blocks. See where he steps out of bounds at.
Right there.
Very close.
No hesitation from the official. Spotted out at the 9.
Here you see Mickey Joseph again coming down the sidelines. The official's right on the play. Very close.
Yes, it was. But I would have to say, as you point out, with the view the official had of Mickey Joseph, he was out of bounds. Very tough to tell.
Looks to me like he's in bounds. And you see him walking the tightrope in this sidelines. I tell you, it's close.
36-yard gain. First and goal, Nebraska. In the opening moments of the third quarter, the Huskers lead 6-0. Scott Baldwin, the ball carrier, he's down at the 6.
As much abuse as the officials are taking this year, both in college and pros, you watch a pro game sometimes, officials, the players seem to be arguing with the officials. I think officials in football should be given a technical foul, maybe a 5-yard penalty when somebody questions a call on the field, because it's almost like players are upstaging the officials anymore.
Well, they can throw the flag for unsportsmanlike conduct.
And they're a little hesitant because it's such a big penalty.
Yes, indeed. The option, Baldwin, driven out of bounds by Tim James at the 5. You have to wonder, if there isn't something wrong with Leotis Flowers, because Scott Baldwin has seen most of the action at the end of the second, quarter, and now here at the beginning of the third quarter.
Well, they play so many players. Here again, you see the option is stringing it out by Alfred Williams. He's the one that makes this play because he strings it out enough to give the secondary, Tim Jeans, a chance to come up and make the pitch and to stop the play and knock the pitch man out of bounds.
Third and goal. From just outside the four-yard line. Baldwin again. Down at the three.
Now here's where that out-of-bounds call becomes very big, because if he was in bounds, they'd take a touchdown away. Toss sweep right here to Scott Baldwin. But again, Colorado's getting up the field on the play. 48, Terry Johnson makes the play out of Kansas City, Missouri.
Greg Barrios to try for his third field goal of the day. This one a 20-yarder. He has already connected from 26 and 44. That one is no good. Tough angle from in close along the hash mark. Barrios hooks it wide, and the Cornhuskers come up empty. Well, you're right about that call along the sideline, although I think if they went by the NFL replay system, it would have been judged inconclusive, and the play would have stood as called.
He just hooks this field goal, just misses.
Still 6-0 Nebraska, and we'll return to Lincoln after this.
1966, Volvo introduces the 140. 1975, Volvo introduces the 240. 1983, Volvo introduces the 760. Now in 1990, Volvo introduces the 940, a Volvo so elegant and richly appointed, you don't have to crash it to appreciate its beauty.
So your little brother's joining us, huh?
He's not so little anymore.
All right, now let's move it!
He's what, 19?
White setting, 540, F-14.
Jeff's landing planes?
Four gear lens set.
No. $40 million jets.
Today's Navy. High-tech training that takes you only one way. Full speed ahead.
Primary's off.
Good job, Dad. You and the
Navy! Jeff?
See? He's not so little anymore.
ESPN's presentation of CFA football, Colorado versus Nebraska, is being brought to you by Volvo, the car that's famous for its safety, durability, and longevity. And by Howard Johnson. Where are you going this fall? Go anywhere and get in on the fall sale at Howard Johnson. Just a mile away from Memorial Stadium, the state capital of Nebraska here in Lincoln. 6-0 Nebraska for the locals. Probably feel as though it should be 13-0. Again, this the play involving Mickey Joseph when he appeared to go in for the touchdown but was ruled out at the 9-yard line. Tough to tell either way.
I think he was in.
George Hemingway, the fullback. A tough run and a gain of four. Here's Tim Brando.
We'd like to welcome those of you that have been watching this game. Georgia Tech Scott Sisson, 37 yards away. He boots it through. The Ramblin' Wreck knock off number one Virginia, last week's number one. Could Nebraska be number one, provided they have a convincing second half, Sean McDonough? Perhaps, just perhaps. Notre Dame gave up 31 today to Navy, but then again, they're Notre Dame. The Irish will be number one next week.
Mike, I think if Nebraska wins this football game, they have to be number one.
I think Nebraska's number one right now at this play.
Eric Bieniemy manages to make something out of nothing. A gain of three out to the 27.
Kevin, they're number one right now. Now, without, I don't care about the pose. If they have somebody moving in front of them with a loss, you can't move somebody with a loss in front of them. And I think right now the crowd is just, it's been announced here, and it's a little bit more momentum for them. But I'll tell you, they're in a dogfight right here right now. But as of right now, Nebraska should be number one. Now, whether they can hold on to it remains to be seen the rest of this half.
The rap against Nebraska at this point is that they haven't played anybody, and I think that's fair criticism. Their non-conference schedule includes Oregon State, Baylor, Minnesota. Hagen thrown down. The inspired Cornhuskers know now that Virginia has lost, and Pat Terrence threw Hagen down back at the 22-yard line.
They may give a helmet start to the public address announcer for announcing that score at this point.
Tom Osborne, following this game, plays two regular season road games at Kansas and at Oklahoma. Then a bowl game. Tom Osborne's worst season at Nebraska, 9 wins and 3 losses. That's his worst record. And a punt by Ruin, down to the 37-yard line. Still 6-0, Nebraska.
Something inside telling you to buy a Volvo? The 240 wagon by Volvo. Think of it as a safety deposit box for your valuables. Michelin High Performance Radios. Everything you'd expect from a Michelin. Only faster. Michelin. Because so much is riding on your tires. New West. The new skin scent for him by Aramis.
Godfrey and Kevin Guthrie back at Memorial Stadium in Lincoln, Nebraska. The rap against Nebraska to this point has been their schedule. That's the biggest reason why they have been rated behind Virginia. They are 8-0, but they have not played strong opponents. Colorado far and away the toughest foe that Nebraska has faced to this point. This is Scott Baldwin. Our report from the sideline is that Leotis Flowers has suffered a sprained ankle, and he has not come out of the Nebraska locker room following halftime. So apparently it will be Scott Baldwin, the sophomore from Roselle, New Jersey, as the tailback the rest of the way. Let's go back to the graphic we showed you briefly moments ago. The opponent's winning percentage, 446 against Nebraska. But after today, they can't say that anymore if Nebraska wins this football game.
Well, you play the schedule that's there. Nobody complains about Virginia. They talk about Virginia's schedule, but you complain about it. But the schedule that they've been given to play. And again, when you stand defeated, you beat the best teams you play. You're playing a Colorado team here that's obviously one of the 10 best teams in the country. And if you beat them, you deserve to be number one.
Baldwin picked up the first down.
Mike Berry, the offensive line coach. He worked for Ray Dempsey back at Southern Illinois when they won the national championship. He's an outstanding offensive line coach. They're trying to make some adjustments. They've run the ball well. Turnovers have killed them. When they started to move the football, running the football, Eric Bieniemy with a couple turnovers has really hurt their chances to get down the field and score.
First and 10, Nebraska. The Huskers at their own 47. Inside of 9 minutes to play in the third quarter, John Bostic did not make the catch. The officials ruled that Bostic trapped it. Still not a complete pass thrown by either team in this football game.
You can see Mickey Joseph's hands are cold. He comes out on the option, throws the ball. It's a wobbly duck right there, and he just got it too low. It was definitely on hit the ground.
Well, pheasant hunting season began today in the state of Nebraska.
We're allowed to hear some gunshots at that ball.
I think a few of the hunters were aiming at that football. Baldwin.
you have to be impressed with Baldwin. The depth of a team like Nebraska, where they have 180 players on the squad. Here you've got Scott Baldwin coming in for Leotis Flowers. They don't miss a beat. Here's the isolation play again. Look at the penetration that Colorado gets, but Scott Baldwin makes the cut, holds on to football, gets good yardage. Now here's a third down situation for Mickey Joseph. Here's that unbalanced line again where they ran the option before. Look for the option here.
On third down and four. The give to Lewis. And he did not pick up the first down. He got just a yard to the 45. Fourth down and three. The decision facing Tom Osborne. Kerry Johnson, number 48, made the tackle for Colorado.
He doesn't have any decision right here. He's got to punt the ball. He's got the wind, play field position, punt him in the hole, and try to keep him there.
McLuhan moves back to receive the punt. One of the benefits of the easy schedule for Nebraska to this point is that they've been able to use a lot of people. And even though Baldwin has backed up a great back like Flowers all year long, he had carried the ball 50 times coming into today, so he's not untested.
Well, the one thing about playing a lot of players, I don't think Nebraska is really the only team I've ever seen be able to do that. How do you keep them all happy and role players? But Tom Osborne has done a very good job doing that.
The punt went through the end zone by Stiggy.
Let's go,
Tom Osborne has used 20 different running backs to carry the football this year. 9 different rushers have scored a touchdown. It's not only Baldwin who's seen action as a backup, but several other Cornhuskers as well. They've rolled to an 8-0 record, outscoring their opponents by an average of 44-8 per game. The enemy, a gain of 2, and that is all. Leandre Anderson made the tackle. With all the talk about Nebraska's schedule, yesterday I put the question to Tom Osborne. What are his thoughts about all the hullabaloo?
Well, I say they may be right. We don't know. We'll find out a little bit more when we play Colorado. We think some of the teams that we've played are a little bit better than a lot of people are giving them credit for, but we have not played an overwhelming schedule, and we understand that.
Sean, this is an important series for Colorado and Nebraska because Colorado, they can go into the fourth quarter. They're going to get the win.
Here's the first completion of the football game and a first down for Colorado. George Hemingway, an excellent receiver out of the backfield, brings Colorado out to the 40-yard line.
It's a counter pass that Darian Hagan faced Eric Bieniemy. George Hemingway slips right underneath the inside backer. He's open. Darian Hagan finds him for the first completion of the day. And then George picks up good yardage after. He's able to avoid a couple tackles and make a big play. As I was saying, if Nebraska has 6:32 on the clock with the clock moving to use the win, Nebraska, again, can use this time and get themselves a position where they can throw a little bit more in the fourth quarter. They're not in bad shape.
Hemingway into the line for 2 on first down, out to the 43-yard line. Hemingway's a converted tight end. Jerry DiNardo, the offensive coordinator for Colorado, said of the many things Hemingway does well, his most impressive attribute is his ability to catch the football out of the backfield, as we just saw.
Being a tight end, he's able to go up in the one back set and play at an almost like a tight end position so that they get a tight end and a fullback in the offense at the same time.
Play action pass, Hagan going deep into the wind. Pritchard makes the catch. Great adjustment to the football by Mike Pritchard, and he's down to the 21 of Nebraska.
Several times during a football game, Colorado's going to throw the ball deep. Here, Darian Hagan, again, a veteran. He's been in these kind of ball games. The one thing about playing the schedule they've played, they've been in tough games all year. It's a post pattern that hangs up because it's thrown into the wind. And Pritchard does a better job of rerouting and making the play. Watch him just time his jump just right.
Pickens and Lewis were there for Nebraska, but it was Pritchard with the big catch. Hagan fighting the crowd noise. Bieniemy lost it again. Still free.
critical mistake by Nebraska. If they don't recover this, one of their players tried to pick it up.
They did recover. Mike Kroll came up with the football. What a terrible day Eric Bieniemy is having. That's the third fumble for Bieniemy that has been lost by the Buffaloes.
Colorado has to overcome frustration now because they moved the ball down in pretty good shape. Watch Eric Bieniemy again, cut back. He just drops the football. He was trying to move it, and it hit, looked like it hit his hip and came out.
Third fumble lost for Colorado, all three from Bieniemy. He's actually fumbled four times. They got one of those back. After you fumbled that many times, wouldn't you be more conscious of it? Wouldn't your first thought be to protect the football?
Sometimes in this kind of game, you want to carry it with two hands and forget about trying to stiff arm anybody or use your hand as a other hand as a direction hand. So you try to cover it with both hands. But he just dropped the football. He had it pinned on his arm, and it just got loose. Here's the unbalanced line again by Nebraska.
The Cornhuskers lead 6-0. Past the midway point of the third quarter. Lance Lewis battled for a couple of yards, crossed the 20 and down at the 22, a pickup of three.
Bill McCartney's done a great job. 1-10 in 1984, he's brought this program to prominence in West Virginia, and Don Allen had a president named Dr. Gordon G. He was a West Virginia when they were strong and played for the national title. He went to Colorado. Their football program became very strong. Now he's at Ohio State. He may be the most valuable college president in the country.
Good for the Buckeyes to bounce back. Joseph couldn't bounce away from McLuhan. That's a loss of one back to the 21. The clock continues to run. And we have a combination of rain and snow that has begun to fall here in Lincoln. Hasn't really rained in earnest since the start of the football game. It rained hard here all morning, but the rain is coming down again. A little bit of sleet in the air as well.
Winter is here.
Yes, it is. It was Indian summer Thursday in the mid-70s. Now in the mid-30s and going down. Third down. 8 yards to go for Nebraska first down. Joseph, that's the first completion for Nebraska. John Bostic a first down and more. Out to the 45-yard line.
To date, that is the biggest play in this football game for Nebraska offensively. They're able to get out of the hole, keep the drive going, and keep using the wind a little bit. Here you see the counteraction and the route being run by John Bostic. Again, it's not so much that he makes the catch. Look at the yardage he gets after the catch.
Bostic, the leading receiver for Nebraska this year. That was his 13th reception. Scott Baldwin. Excellent balance. He's close to a first down in Colorado territory at the 46.
Scott Baldwin took the toss sweep and cut it inside, drew the defense inside, and was able to break it outside, break a couple tackles, and pick up 9 yards. Very important drive for Nebraska. They've got to try to put Colorado away right now.
They have the wind behind them for another 2 minutes and 52 seconds. Second less than a yard. Joseph looking to throw. Man wide open, the tight end, Johnny Mitchell. Touchdown, Nebraska.
One of the only two freshmen to be playing for Nebraska this year. When you run the option, you lull the secondary to sleep a little bit. Mickey Joseph comes down, looks back, throws the ball to Johnny Mitchell, the true freshman, puts it on the money, and again, very important at this stage that they used the win. They did. It was a good call by Tom Osborne. Puts them up 12 to nothing. Now they might go for 2 points, John.
Some confusion along the Nebraska sideline. A couple of officials over there. No indication that Nebraska has used a timeout, but certainly the Cornhuskers are talking things over. That was Mitchell's seventh reception of the year. Five of them have gone for touchdowns. A lot of that is the element of surprise in the passing game.
Well, it is. Your point's well taken. When you're a play-action passing team, you're going to have those kind of statistics that you see right there. Johnny, seven receptions, 163 yards, but an average of 23.2. Drop-back passers won't have that type of statistics because you're throwing mostly on passing situations, and people expect that. They don't expect it out of run teams. They're going for two to try to get the point total to 14.
On the scoreboard, Nebraska was not charged with a timeout. Joseph throws short. Intended for Dan Pleasant, the backup split end, but the pass was short. Six more points on the board for the Cornhuskers. Late in the third quarter, they lead 12 to nothing.
Before long, his phone was helping him handle more business. In fact, business got so good, Bob had to buy more Centel cellular phones to go with his new trucks.
Starting a new business is tough, but in my case, State Representative Frank Sawyer made it easier by helping me cut through government's red tape.
When I was injured on the job, I had some problems with workers' compensation. Thanks to the help of Frank Sawyer, I got the help I needed.
Government should work for the people, not for itself. And with 8 years as state representative, I know how to get the job done for the people of Richland County.
State Representative Frank Sawyer is making a difference for the people of Richland County. Frank Sawyer, when he wins, we all win.
November 11th on ESPN Sunday Night NFL. The San Francisco 49ers face the Dallas Cowboys. The San Francisco 49ers, the world champions, drive for their third consecutive title, led by perhaps the most awesome offense ever. The Dallas Cowboys have upset on their mind as they strive to regain the title of America's team. The 49ers face the Cowboys coming November 11th at 8 Eastern, live on ESPN Sunday Night NFL.
12-0 Nebraska, following the first touchdown of the football game. 2:38 to play in the third quarter. The drive following the Bieniemy fumble covered 80 yards in five plays. Johnny Mitchell, the touchdown reception from 46 yards.
They also drew a 15-yard penalty for celebrating the touchdown, and they're back kicking off from the 20-yard line.
Byron Bennett to kick off. With that stiff breeze at his back. Dwayne Davis starts from the 12. Good job to stay on his feet. And he brings it out close to the 30-yard line. Robert Hicks made the tackle on special teams for Nebraska. Well, Bill McCartney told Kevin Guthrie at halftime, if they're considerably behind heading into the fourth quarter, they're going to throw the ball regularly with that win. They don't have the wind at the moment. Still 2.5 minutes to play in the third quarter.
Biggest thing Colorado offensively has to overcome is the frustration of moving the football but having the turnovers.
The reverse. Blockers for Pritchard. Mike Pritchard across midfield. And down at the 40-yard line of Nebraska. Taken down from behind by Reggie Cooper. Flag down. A late flag way downfield back at the 32-yard line. And the Colorado coach is all over the official on the near side of the field who threw the flag.
First down.
play action, looks like a pass, and all of a sudden the reverse. Mike Pritchard comes around, good speed, good blocking right here. Almost breaks us for a touchdown. Reggie Cooper ends up making the close on him and makes a tackle, but again, frustration, turnovers, penalties, take away a lot of the big plays.
Apparently the man flagged was Jay Lewenberg, the center, number 52, as he was blocking Mike Kroll. He was the only blocker in the vicinity where the flag was thrown at the 32-yard line. There's a catch by Rico Smith. He's back across midfield. So after the disappointing penalty, the Buffaloes bounce right back with the big gainer Hagan to Rico Smith.
We don't play the schedule that they played and not be a good football team. They played great teams all year and have come back to win. Darren Hagan's a money player. He puts this ball right on the mark to Rico Smith. Good throw, underplayed a little bit by Tyrone Bird. He just didn't time it right.
First down, Colorado. A minute 45 to play in the third quarter. Nebraska leads 12 to nothing. The enemy had the football wrapped up. He has another first down, down to the 36-yard line, down along the sidelines, Kevin Guthrie.
Sidelines. Colorado's coaching staff has done a super job of keeping them up. All these frustrating things happening, they have gotten behind in a lot of games this season, and they're hanging in there. You see it. They just keep coming back, and they're waiting for the win. Back to you, Sean and Mike.
Hey, Kevin, tell those people you're on national TV. All those folks cutting in front of Kevin.
Hey, Colorado's putting on an impressive drive.
Bieniemy. Back to the line of scrimmage. Joe Sims got up from the bottom of the pile defensively for Nebraska.
Talked to coaches around the country last year, of course, with the death of Sal and Essie and the focus, tremendous focus that Colorado had on their season. They were also focused every ball game, the 12 games throughout the season. You don't have a team focused that much like they were last year. This year, the focus hasn't been as good. You couldn't expect it to be like it was last year. But again, a good comeback football team.
Saw the numbers for Bieniemy, but the big number, the three lost fumbles. Hagan knocked out of bounds at the 33-yard line. Darian Hagan will have the windows back in the fourth quarter, but Bill McCartney told us last night he thinks Darian throws the ball better into the wind, even a strong wind like today. Every pass he's completed today has been into this wind. He feels like when Hagan throws the ball with the wind, the ball tends to sail, and that's something we'll look for in the fourth quarter.
I've been impressed with his last two throws. You know, his jersey's wet, his hands are wet. Usually inside, you'd have a towel or something to clear his hands a little bit, but it doesn't look like he has it. It has it off the left of him right there, but that's probably wet also. So he's throwing the ball well with the wet football.
Very little success on third down for Colorado. 1 for 9 are the Buffaloes. They go to the ground. Bieniemy spins for the first down. Eric Bieniemy down at the 23-yard line with a first down for Colorado with 33 seconds left in the third quarter.
Well, Bieniemy's just pumping it up in there right now. He's like a man possessed. He wants to come back and make up for those fumbles. He's as good a back as there is in this league or probably in America this year, college football. Bill McCartney knows he's got a nice drive going. He's going to be able to come away with some points on this drive.
Bieniemy got in for only one play last year against Nebraska because he was injured. Colorado coaches say he's really been looking forward to this game. At this point, it's been a disappointment for him, but he's trying to atone for the fumbles on this important drive in the final seconds of the third quarter. The only scoring in the third quarter, the touchdown pass. Joseph to Mitchell, the 46 yards. Nebraska looking ahead to the possible number one ranking, leading 12-0.
Dear Rayovac, I've had a battery-operated back scratcher in the drawer for years and years. We had two Rayovac batteries in it. I turned it on, and lo and behold, they were still good. We were really surprised, and so was everyone else. No one believed it until we showed them that they still worked. How's that for good batteries? Sincerely, Mrs. Margaret Bronert, Cincinnati, Ohio.
Rayovac. Batteries that turn people on. How do you get real premium beer taste in a non-alcoholic brew? You start with a real premium beer. That's how Anheuser-Busch makes O'Doul's.
O'Doul's is carefully brewed, fully fermented, and cold-aged. Then the alcohol is naturally removed, retaining all the great taste. So how do you get real premium beer taste in a non-alcoholic brew? Ask for an ice-cold O'Doul's. O'Doul's, the taste will win you over.
The Turbo Wagon by Volvo. Think of it as a sports car with extra pickup.
Napa, because there are no unimportant parts.
Oh no, the heat pump's pooped.
What?
Well, it's a bit nippy.
Nippy? Are you the weatherman?
You don't have to get rude.
Yes, you do. A Rude heat pump keeps you comfortable all year long and helps lower energy bills year after year.
You want to get comfortable? Get rude.
Hey, hey, where are we going? I was only kidding. Can't you
to get comfortable, you gotta get rude.
Put me down, put me down, put me down!
You can spot someone who saved money with a second-rate antifreeze a mile away. Not all antifreeze is the same. Nothing beats Prestone. And that's something you might appreciate down the road.
This sellout crowd of 76,000 thinking about a possible number one ranking. Colorado deep now in Nebraska territory.
They've got to almost think this is four down territory because you don't get too many scoring opportunities in daylight today.
Hagan tried to throw it left-handed, which he has done in the past, and it's an incomplete pass. Hagan is capable of throwing left-handed. He has completed a pass left-handed this year. That one incomplete as he tried to throw using the left hand.
He is ambidextrous, and he has that ability to go to his left and use his left hand. I don't think the coaches want him to do that. You see him come out here, he'll switch the ball to his left hand and throw it to avoid the sack. Again, a good heady play by a veteran quarterback. Travis Hill put the pressure on him.
It wasn't that close to coming out before his arm was coming forward. He lost that right at the top of his throwing motion. Hagan on third down, throws, caught! At the one-yard line, Mike Pritchard gives Colorado first and goal at the Nebraska one.
What a great route by Mike Pritchard. He ran a shake route, faked the post pattern, and broke back to the corner. Watch Darren Hagan here. Good play fake again. Both teams are play-action teams, not drop-back teams. You see the tight end crossing? Mike Pritchard made a move to the post and then broke to the corner, made the catch, came down in bounds. Bruce Pickens covering.
Mike Pritchard. The enemy into the end zone for a touchdown. Boy, it looked like the wingback was moving toward the line of scrimmage when the ball was snapped, but no flag thrown. And Eric Bieniemy goes in for the touchdown. Colorado is on the board. It's now 12-6.
Colorado has the momentum now in the wind. Eric Bieniemy with the touchdown. Ran in isolation, followed George Hemingway, got in the end zone.
Jim Harper, a perfect 28 for 28 in extra points this year. He's still perfect. It's now 12-7 Nebraska with 14:43 left in the game.
Watch George Hemingway again lead on the isolation and get the good block. Number 93 comes from the backside to make the play, Travis Hill, but the momentum of Eric Bieniemy just took him right into the end zone. See it again. Colorado's got momentum, they've got the wind, and now the pressure goes to Nebraska.
I really still think, Mike, that Michael Simmons, the wingback, number 42, was starting toward the line of scrimmage before that ball was snapped, as he was lined up at his wingback slot. See, he's running that way, but now he's veering. That's not a great angle to see him heading toward the line of scrimmage, or perhaps he wasn't. Maybe he turned just as the ball was snapped, but he was very close to moving up the football field as the ball was snapped.
Well, the one thing that, again, makes it difficult down there when you're playing option teams, that they have the threat of the option, they really cause you some problems in goal line defense. And that's why you saw Nebraska didn't even appear like they got the goal line surge that they'd like to have.
The scoring drive for Colorado, 71 yards, 10 plays, 2:47. The time of possession and a couple of big plays. They bounced back from that potentially critical holding penalty.
I think, again, that's a sign of the schedule they played. They've had to face that type of schedule every week, so they've had to come back. Now they put tremendous pressure on Nebraska. Nebraska now has to fight their defense and the weather. Wind's blowing the ball off the tee. Colorado's going to maybe bring somebody up to hold. They're going to try one more time to go without using somebody to hold the football. Put it in play. Ball's been a little slippery today.
Indeed, it has been. Rain continues to fall. Terrific kick by Harper with the wind at his back. It goes through the end zone, and Nebraska will begin at its own 20.
It might be cold here, but the heat is being turned up on the Nebraska offense right now.
Coming up, I doubt they'll have similar weather conditions at Florida Field as the Gators play host to the Auburn Tigers. Auburn still very much in the national championship picture without a loss. They've escaped a couple of narrow victories for the Tigers along the way. They do have a tie with Tennessee. That's at 7:30 Eastern time tonight. Joseph keeps on the option. Got just across the line of scrimmage, and that's all.
Going into the first half, Nebraska averaged 1.8 yards on first down. The second half, they've averaged 9.5. On this first down play, watch the linebackers again. Shuffle over. Good play. Get up the football field, make the tackle. Greg Bickert on Mickey Joseph. Again, Colorado's got to just keep turning the heat up and make Nebraska try to make a play. Here comes the unbalanced line to the left, so I would expect an option play to the left for Mickey Joseph.
Joseph, they're all out of sync. First, he was maneuvering Baldwin. Then, Terry Eiman, backup tackle, came out of his stance. It'll be a 5-yard walk-off against the Cornhuskers.
This is strong Colorado defense. Nebraska's got their work cut out for them. That man right there is calling every offensive play right now.
Back to the 16-yard line, setting up second and 14. Joseph dumped back at the 12-yard line. Joel Steed, number 93, the nose man, the junior from Denver, made the play.
Joel Steed moves to the right on the center. Look at him, push him up the field, pushed him right into Mickey Joseph. It was pass protection all the way, but the center, David Edeal, gave too much ground. Was able to right in the face of Mickey Joseph.
Now if Nebraska does not come up with a big play in the 18 yards for first down, the Huskers will have to kick into the 25-mile-an-hour breeze. Quarterback draw. Gets nothing. A loss back to the 11-yard line.
Momentum has switched to Colorado ever since the drive just before the change in quarters where they were able to use good ground game in the pass to gain field position back. Now the punt becomes very important. Look for Colorado to hold them up because they had two big punt returns in the game last year. To hold the Nebraska punt team up at the line of scrimmage and then run with them.
Stiggy punting from just inside his own end zone. The deep man McLuhan is at the Nebraska 39. That was untouched by Colorado, therefore downed by Nebraska at the 47. Very nearly a huge error by Rico Smith. The officials rule he did not touch it, and it's a downing of the football by Nebraska at the 47 of Colorado.
I tell you, it's close again, but I'm glad the officials have to make those calls in this particular game. You see it come down. I don't think he touched it.
No, he did not.
See, the one thing that's happened in this game is the punt receivers have allowed the ball to hit the ground, which is they've got to bounce in every case. And where you'd expect it, I expected Colorado to get a little closer field position. Now the Nebraska defense is called on to do what they do best. They've got to shut down the run.
The play. Nebraska leads by five. Bieniemy burst through the middle into Nebraska territory at the 45, 2 yards short of a first down. Here's Kevin Guthrie.
John, you know, things are getting tough for Nebraska on offense, and to make matters worse, they're not going to have the Otis Flowers. I just talked to Jack Nicolaitis, the athletic trainer for Nebraska. He's too sore. He will not be back. John?
We have not seen Leotis Flowers since the second quarter, out with a sprained ankle. Second down, two. Play action pass, deep pass. Pritchard is there. He made the catch. Another super catch by Mike Pritchard along the far sideline.
Nebraska's playing defense. A lot of times you'll turn a receiver like Mike Pritchard to be one-on-one. Watch the linebackers take the fake, play action pass, the hit that Darian Hagan takes after he makes the throw. Mike Pritchard with a good reception. Again, he's one-on-one with Tyrone Leggett.
Mike Pritchard, they call him the booster, a la Notre Dame's rocket. Pritchard came into today's game with just 25 fewer all-purpose yards than the Rocket, Raheem Ismail. But you hear so much about the Rocket, very little about the booster. More people know about the booster now. Here's Bieniemy inside the five, down at the four, a gain of seven. It'll set up second and three. Colorado can pick up a first down without scoring a touchdown. This is what we were talking about the booster. Big play, Mike Pritchard. Look at some of those scoring plays. 78 yards, 70 yards, 68, 55, 44, 30. All of those plays went for touchdowns.
Out of Rancho High School in Las Vegas, Nevada.
When Bieniemy missed the first game of the year, he was the tailback and rushed for 217 yards. Here comes a flag thrown in the middle of the offensive line.
This is a holding call. This is really going to be a tough blow. This will be the first holding call of the day.
Actually, the second, including the play that was called back, the big play, moments ago. But you wonder how, in a football game like this, when they say you can call holding on virtually every play, they wait till a team's down on the 5-yard line and then call a holding penalty.
Well, the way the hold is called is supposed to be if it affects the play. Bill McCartney obviously is not happy there. He would have got one of those early. He's not arguing, but he wants to know why. Here you see just a mass of humanity right there stopping Eric Bieniemy.
Now, Lewenberg might have grabbed the shirt of one of the Nebraska defenders, but I'd bet there's been plenty of action like that in the offensive line on both sides all day.
Tough call right there.
That's right. Why wait till this point of the football game to call holding in the middle of the offensive line? Hagan going to run. He's short of the 5-yard line, about 4 yards short of a first down.
Darian Hagan was able to get outside to contain the player that was able to come up and make the stop, even though he didn't make the tackle, was Kenny Walker coming from the side.
You see Darren Hagan again, the play action fake. Both guards pull, they get outside. Now he's a running threat right now. Watch Kenny Walker right there. Just enough to spin him, slow him down a little bit before they make the tackle. You talk about a big third down play right now. Facing Colorado, they may be in four down territory and they're thinking.
Third and five from the six, pass caught. Now the ball's on the field and the receiver is ruled down. Where will they spot him down though? Where the ball is at the moment, it's very close to a first down. If they spot the receiver down where he was separated from the football, it looks like Colorado would be short of a first down.
Boy, that was executed well on offense and defense. It was a naked play where Darren Hagan came out without any kind of protection.
Ball was fumbled. Will Nature for a first down.
So it was a fumble. Had Nebraska covered, apparently that would have stood.
Here you see the naked play. Darren Hagan fakes the pitch to the side, rolls to the left. Here comes the pressure. He jumps up in the air, got the pass off. And again, executed well on offense by Darren Hagan and on defense by Mike Kroll. Here you got both receivers going for the football. Secondary man and the offensive man, again, just executed very well.
David Brown was the receiver. Colorado short of the first down. They can pick up a first down by gaining just a couple of inches, and they are going to go for it.
I wouldn't be surprised if a quarterback sneak here sits it's inches or something where you get a couple lead blockers ahead of Eric Bieniemy.
Now the play is stopped as Tom Osborne has requested a conference with the officials. John Laurie, the referee, explained it to Tom Osborne, and now the official along the near sideline is explaining the situation to Bill McCartney.
These are two coaches that aren't very, you won't see a lot of motion out of them in the ball game, and they're very much in control of their particular sidelines and teams. Both done an excellent job in this conference. I can't tell you how far Bill McCartney's brought this team.
One of the biggest plays of the year in college football. Fourth and inches. They can pick up a first down without scoring a touchdown. A long count. Hagan trying to draw them offside. It did not work, and he used the timeout just as the play clock was about to expire. Still 12-7, Nebraska.
Introducing the new Dodge Stealth RT Turbo, dedicated to those who thought Ferrari Testarossa couldn't be beat 0 to 60.
The Stealth really smoked it.
Who thought Porsche Carrera couldn't be out-cornered.
The Stealth just blew it away.
Who thought Lotus would save Europe today?
The Stealth just plain beat it.
Introducing the new all-wheel drive Stealth RT Twin Turbo. Performance that's bringing America home to Dodge.
Okay. But just suppose another tornado rips up our Meadville plant. Then what? Or suppose we have a string of accidents, like we did in 86. Suppose I get sick again. Would another insurance company come through like the people from the Hartford? I doubt it. And after 14 years, this fella is not about to find out.
ITT Hartford, when you need us most, we're at our best.
Imagine a rent-a-car company that offers special delivery right to your door. That's Enterprise.
Here, let me help you.
And remember, when you return the car, Enterprise will be glad to drop you home. Enterprise, a special rent-a-car company that gives you special delivery.
ESPN's presentation of CFA football, Colorado versus Nebraska, is being brought to you by Dodge. For performance, quality, safety, and value, welcome home, America. And by Bud Light. Everything else is just a light.
Colorado on the last play
didn't have any intention of running the play. They, exactly what you said, Sean, they were trying to draw them off sides, but also they were trying to give their coaches upstairs a chance to see what Nebraska's in defensively. Just like basketball coaches do when they set up and look for the defense and then call timeout. Again, I still look for quarterback sneak of the enemy behind the two lead blockers.
And one of the biggest plays of the year in college football, Bienemy leaps. Touchdown. The official along the far side of the field did not signal touchdown, but the official along the near side did. And Colorado has the lead 13-12, and you saw the indication that Colorado will go for 2 points.
Well, earlier when Nebraska went for two, the reason they went for two was because they needed to get to 14. Now Colorado will go for two. Here you see the play, just again, good surge by the Colorado offensive line. The enemy over the top. Right now, I said earlier, they were number one. They've just lost their number one ranking here on that play.
And it's anybody's guess as to who is number one on this play. 13-12, Colorado with 8:37 to play. And the Buffaloes took too much time.
Now I think you have to kick the extra point. I know you want to be 3 points up for the field goal, but I don't know if you got a high percentage play enough to get you in the end zone now.
Well, part of the problem was that the Buffaloes were so busy celebrating after the touchdown that Darian Hagan was running around conversing with some of his teammates, and he wasn't ready for the two-point play possibility. They took a while to get the word to him they were going to get huddled, get ready, and they took too much time.
Well, you need 2 points here. You have to have it. I'm just saying the percentage is now low, but they're going to go for two. Probably the right choice right here by Bill McCartney, because two is really what you need.
One doesn't do much good. It only gives you a two-point lead. Then a field goal beats you. Man open, but it's too high for Pritchard. That could be big as we look back on it.
No harm really there, because again, a field goal, if you would have kicked one, beat you anyway, but the percentages were low for him.
Colorado leads for the first time in the football game, 13-12 with 8:37 remaining.
When rain comes into view, rain. Warm air surrounding you.
Call me rain.
The air of quality.
Rain.
When winter hits your neighborhood, warm up with a reliable, high-efficiency Rheem heat pump that'll keep you cool all summer, too, and save money year-round.
Hey, Rheem, call me Rheem. Rheem, the air of quality. Call me Rheem.
Introducing the new Dodge Stealth RT Turbo, dedicated to those who thought Ferrari Testarossa couldn't be beat 0-60.
The Stealth really smoking.
Who thought Porsche Carrera couldn't be out-cornered?
The Stealth just blew it away.
Who thought Lotus would save Europe today?
The Stealth just plain beat it.
Introducing the new all-wheel drive Stealth RT Twin Turbo. Performance that's bringing America home to Dodge.
I burn with desire each time my heart fans the fire to that old flame that burns inside of me. There's nobody in his right mind would have left her. Even my heart was small.
The music of George Strait, brought to you by Bud Light.
Sean McDonough with Mike Gottfried and Kevin Guthrie back at Memorial Stadium in Lincoln, Nebraska. The number one team has already lost today. Virginia suffering its first defeat of the season. Nebraska trying to avoid its first loss. But the Huskers trail now 13-12 following the two-yard touchdown run by Eric Bieniemy that capped a 53-yard drive. Encompassing six plays, it took 3 minutes and 37 seconds.
Colorado's dominated this football game on offense. The turnovers have been the reason that they're only up by 1 point right now.
Jim Harper to kick off. His last kickoff sailed through the end zone with that wind at his back. This shorter taken by Tyrone Hughes at the four. He's down at the 21. Once again, here's Kevin Guthrie.
And Mike, you know, this is a situation where we were on the Colorado side of the field and they were turning the ball over and getting big plays against them. They were getting angry. After that touchdown on the Nebraska side, the Nebraska players hung their heads a little bit and turned away from the sideline. Now, you see a Nebraska team right now that has never been behind in the fourth quarter, and it's going to be a big test now. It's gut check time. Sean and Mike.
One of the criticisms of Nebraska football over the last couple of decades really has been the inability to win the big ones. This is a big one. They've squandered a 12-0 lead, and they're in trouble again. Mickey Joseph thrown down by Alfred Williams for a loss back inside the 20 at the 17-yard line.
Watch Alfred Williams, number 94. Comes up, plays the guard on the option. Number 61, Eric Weigart, gets rid of him, then makes the play on Mickey Joseph. They're going to force Mickey Joseph to throw the football if they're going to beat Colorado.
Joseph, good pitch to Baldwin. He's short of a first down at the 27-yard line. That'll bring up third down and four for the Huskers with 7:50 left. Colorado leads by a point.
Little different option this time, and they block Alfred Williams this time. So they're able to get the pitch past him and get it out to Baldwin, and then he's finally tackled by Deion Figures.
Nebraska just 1 of 13 on third down conversions today, and they won't pick this one up. Baldwin stopped well short of the first down at the 28-yard line. Joel Steed made the tackle again for the Buffaloes.
It's too early to go for this one. You've got to punt the football now and play field position. Colorado has everything going in their favor right now. The weather, the lead, and they're now going to have good field position.
And clearly the momentum is also on Colorado's side. Mike Stiggy has punted well on this windy day. He's been aided by some nice bounces. The fake. And it looks like they stopped him short.
Depends where they mark this one.
Looks like they're going to mark it on the 30-yard line. They needed to reach the 31. The ball went to Yonk, the short man, and he didn't get there. They're going to measure it, but this is just a formality, it would appear, from our vantage point.
I think you're right. I think it is short. Gutsy call by Tom Osborne.
He did not make it.
Here's the fake. Just a snap to the personal protector. He follows the block. He just went inside. There was nothing there. Colorado did a nice job, special teams-wise, of stopping that play.
Big gamble by Tom Osborne. The ball was snapped to Tim Young. He was stopped short of a first down by a yard. The Buffaloes take over at the Nebraska 30, leading 13-12 with 6:38 to play. The enemy. To the 27, a gain of three.
You look at Colorado and the schedule they played this year, they're almost like Louisville in basketball. You always talk about Denny Crum, the schedule he plays that very tough schedule all through the season, and maybe doesn't win as many games as a lot of number one teams that are ranked do, but then when tournament time comes, they're ready to play. Colorado seems to be peaking. As the season goes on, they peak and get better every week. They've really done a great job coming from behind.
8 100-yard games for Bieniemy this year, 19 for his career. That is also a Colorado record. He's only been held under 100 once. That was against Texas. He got 99 against the Longhorns. He's down this time. Again, the ball came free, but it was after Bieniemy was down with the first down at the 19-yard line.
Well, now it becomes smash-mouth football because Colorado is just going to run this football right at Nebraska and make them stop him. Use the clock. Try to make them stop them and get in position at least for a field goal. But I think they're thinking more in terms of trying to push this one across and in this game right now.
Bieniemy inside the 10, down at the 9, again close to a first down.
But the way this game's going, Sean, if Colorado should continue and win this football game, then, of course, it puts the number one ranking up for grabs for a lot of teams. I think Auburn's a factor going into their game tonight. Of course, they don't want anybody to talk about it, probably to put that jinx on them, because it seems like it is a jinx right now. Houston, you got to look at, who's undefeated. Notre Dame, I'm sure, Miami. But Colorado's not out of this thing either, because if they win this game, go to the Orange Bowl, draw a top team, they may have a chance to still play for the number one ranking.
Hemingway, Bulls down to the 3-yard line. In the process, he picks up a first down. First and goal, Colorado. Well, two blocked field goals. That would separate Bill McCartney from an undefeated season.
You got to admire the team, the way they played this year with the schedule. Coming into the season, there were a lot of people's pick for the number one team in the country.
The enemy up the middle, touchdown.
Gotta admire Eric Bieniemy. He's come back. He had a couple of fumbles, but he has fought back. He didn't go over and put his head down and complain or cry. He just kept fighting back and now has scored a couple of touchdowns and put his team in the big lead.
Harper trying to make it an 8-point Colorado advantage with 4:35 remaining. Nebraska had allowed just one rushing touchdown all year. Colorado has scored three times on the ground today.
Offense, still the extra point.
This is a big point here, because if by some possibility Nebraska can score, go the length of field and score a touchdown, this puts it to 8 and force them to go to 2.
Just a tie. Harper drills it through. The touchdown by Eric Bieniemy gives Colorado an 8-point lead.
And proposed one strengthening drug education in our schools. Lee Fisher for Kids. Outraged by the early release of violent criminals, he worked for mandatory sentences to keep them behind bars. Lee Fisher for Safer Streets. From crime victims' assistance to his Tough on Toxics plan, this award-winning lawyer and legislator is fighting to protect Ohio's families. Lee Fisher for Attorney General.
Are you concerned about crime in your community? Ron Spahn is.
Over the last 16 years, I've prosecuted more than 1,000 criminal cases for the citizens of Richland County. I believe that the public has a fundamental right to live free from the fear of criminal harm. The next judge must impose tough penalties against dangerous criminals. That's my commitment to you.
The only choice with years of criminal trial experience. Vote Ron Spahn, a strong court for a safe Richland County.
NASCAR's Winston Cup Championship can't get much closer. Mark Martin and Dale Earnhardt continue to grind it out at the Checker 500. Plus, you could win a new car Sunday afternoon live on ESPN.
The world's top players are there, but only one can win the crown. See the finals of the Paris Open indoors Sunday afternoon at 1 Eastern on ESPN.
Colorado with 20 points here in the fourth quarter has come from 12-0 down to take a 20-12 lead. Remember, Nebraska had only given up 22 points all year in the second half prior to today's football game.
Well, Bill McCartney liked his chances going into the fourth quarter with the win. He said he was going to open it up a little bit, but he's had great field position with the win in the fourth quarter to get those 20 points.
Harper's kick. Tyrone Hughes started at the 1. Ripped up as he was eyeing some open running room along the far sideline. He went down right at the 20 as David Gibbs made the tackle on special teams for the Buffaloes. 30 yards following the fake punt. 2:03 the time. Bieniemy, the touchdown.
Now you force Nebraska into doing what they don't do quite so well, is throw the football.
The option, the pitch bobbled, and Joseph got it back.
Colorado's been able all day, except for the long run where Mickey Joseph went down the sideline, to contain the option. Here the pitch was there, just dropped by Tyrone Hughes. Very fortunate for Nebraska that Mickey Joseph was able to get on the ball.
Mike, I'm sure the Nebraska fans will question the fake punt when the game is over, but facing the punt into the wind anyway, they were looking at perhaps a net gain of 20 or 25 yards, which is or is not significant depending on how you look at it, but not a bad gamble given the wind that the punt was going to have to go into. Joseph back to the 15.
I'm sure Tom Osborne may be thinking a little bit about the backup quarterback right now, Mike Grant, to bring him in, but it'd be very difficult because of the cold weather, and you got the guy with a hood on over on the sideline the whole game. Mickey Joseph's really going to have to be the guy to pull this one out. He's going to have to throw the football to pull it out.
The clock ticks down to 3:05 remaining. Colorado leads 20-12. On 3rd and 15, Joseph throws, caught, and then dropped and ruled incomplete. Johnny Mitchell had it in his hands and was coming down with it, but it's ruled an incomplete pass as he could not hang on at the 32-yard line. It would have been a first down.
Well, Johnny Mitchell, again, an excellent young tight end, goes up for the football, stretches out to get it. Looks like he's got it, trying to bring it back into his body. Just never controlled it. It just rolled off and wasn't able to hold on. They've got to go for this fourth down play. Tom Osborne has no other choice at this particular point. He's got to throw the football up the field to try to pick this first down up.
Fourth and 15. Joseph in a crowd and sacked.
I think they may have just went from number one to maybe around the 10th spot. And Colorado now has put themselves in a position to go to the Orange Bowl and possibly play for the national championship.
You look at the two blemishes on the Buffaloes' record, the tie with Tennessee to start the season in the Pigskin Classic. They had a blocked field goal in that one. And the one-point loss to Illinois, they had a field goal blocked in that one.
Both good teams. Johnny Major's Tennessee teams played well all year. Good, solid coach football team. In Illinois under John Makovic, again, good team. But they also beat a Washington team that I think is a very strong football team. Texas, another team that probably will be a big bowl game team on in January 1st.
Bieniemy down to the 5, down to 2:45 left in the fourth quarter, 20-12 Colorado. The question certainly will be, who is number one after this football game? Tough to look past that Houston team.
Well, it is difficult when you're undefeated. I'm still a believer in that. When you're undefeated, you play who you're asked to play, and you win every game. The tough thing for Houston is they're not going to be able to go to a bowl this year. Again, I wouldn't count Miami and Notre Dame and teams with now it's up for grabs again because Virginia losing. Georgia Tech still doesn't have a loss. They've got a tie. You got Auburn with that tie, but they've got a tough ball game ahead of them tonight.
Hemingway into the line. For little or no gain, even the Auburn Tigers have been the first to admit that they are fortunate to be undefeated. They know that they have run out of good fortune, that they've dodged several bullets against lightly regarded opponents, and they do have a tie. They do not have a perfectly unblemished record.
You know, sometimes you got to win those kind of games. You got to be a little bit lucky, too. But this would be a great year for a playoff because you got so many teams that are close to equal with a loss or a tie that this would be a great time to have that playoff. It'll come within the next 5 years. There's no doubt about it. But this would have been the year because you have maybe 6-8 teams that could qualify for that.
Third down and goal from the 5.
This man has done an outstanding coaching job, Bill McCartney.
1984, as I said earlier, 1-10. And he's brought this program along, and now as good as there is in the Big Eight.
Touchdown, Bieniemy. That will put it away for Colorado.
Nebraska's had a tough fourth quarter. That wind and field position and not being able to get anything going offensively just has put them in tremendous difficulties. A tough way to end your senior season. That's usually an emotional game when you're playing your last home game, and this group of seniors has had so much success.
Harper kicks the extra point. With a minute 31 to play, Bill McCartney and the Buffaloes enjoy a 27-12 lead.
Well, they know they're going to be warm come January 1st because they're going to be in Miami right now unless they stumble along the way. But again, there's Eric Bieniemy following George Hemingway on that isolation. They've had so much success with that all day. Watch the block on the center. Here comes George Hemingway. Blocking on the linebacker, Eric Bieniemy, just they get all those big linemen on you, and he just picks a hole and picks a little seam and finds the touchdown. And again, a happy Eric Bieniemy. His day completely changed around here in the fourth quarter. I don't think he's even cold. Do you?
Well, we're cold enough for him. You're absolutely right. A huge step toward Colorado's second consecutive Big Eight title. And Orange Bowl bid taken here today. They will be the only unbeaten team in the Big Eight after this victory with a record of 5-0. They have two games remaining in Big Eight play. Jim Harper to kick off.
Nebraska is a tough place to play. Colorado came in here and silenced this crowd in the fourth quarter.
Nate Turner isn't going to try it. And Nebraska will get the football at the 20-yard line. As soon as this game is over, we'll head for the warm environs of Florida Field in Gainesville, Florida, the 15th-ranked Gators, in a crucial SEC matchup with Auburn, ranked number 4 in the nation, perhaps number 1 next week with a victory in that game. A win at Florida would really help Auburn's cause as far as claiming the number 1 ranking is concerned.
Mike Grant's in the quarterback, Sean, for Nebraska.
He might be a slightly better thrower than Joseph. He's off the mark with his first toss intended for Tyrone Hughes. So Colorado will defeat Oklahoma and Nebraska in consecutive years. Beat Oklahoma and Nebraska last year on the way to the undefeated regular season and Big Eight championship. They defeated Oklahoma last week. They're about to defeat Nebraska this week. The last time Colorado defeated Oklahoma and Nebraska in consecutive years, 1960 and 1961.
Not many people have been able to do it.
This will also be Colorado's first win here in Lincoln since 1967, and it will snap Nebraska's 19-game home winning streak. And Tom Osborne will again hear about Nebraska's inability to win the big one.
You know, Colorado was involved in that fifth down play, and Bill McCartney got a lot of criticism on that, but I think you have to look at it that they, both teams were affected by the officials there, because had they known it was a fourth down before, I doubt if they'd have grounded the ball, they'd have probably ran the option at that particular time. So just an unfortunate incident that he's being blamed for, and I just don't think the criticism is just. You know.
But it's an excellent point you raise, because without that victory over Missouri, it's an entirely different story in the Big Eight.
It is, but again, both teams were affected by the officials' call, not just one. And it's a tough loss for Missouri, and that's, you really feel for them, but I think you have to understand that maybe the strategy would have been a little different if they had the right down up.
Stiggy, the punter, kicks it away with nobody back for Colorado. They don't risk the punt being mishandled. And the ball rolls dead at the 31-yard line. The point you raise is a valid one as well, because Charles Johnson, who was the quarterback in that football game for Colorado, would not have intentionally thrown the ball into the ground to stop the clock if he knew it was fourth down. The down marker showed third down. That's what he thought it was, and that is why he stopped the clock. The Ream players of the game. For Colorado, Eric Bieniemy. 137 yards rushing and four touchdowns today for Bieniemy, overcoming the fumble problems. Kenny Walker, the standout defensive tackle, the Ream player of the game for Nebraska. Bieniemy comes to the sidelines. He'll sit out the final minute and 2 seconds.
They'll just kill the clock now. Just try to get down on one knee and run the clock. Nebraska on third downs today were 2 out of 16. Just you can't win football games and you can't keep the first down. You can't keep the stakes moving. Missed. I'll tell you who we missed today. Ralphie, the Buffalo. They didn't bring him along. And I remember when I was coaching at Kansas, we had the lead on Colorado. We were playing over there. We were real excited. And we were on the sideline and saying our prayer at halftime, just before the start of the half. And some one of the managers, Speck Ellison, said, "Here comes Ralphie," and everybody dove out of the way. But that's one of the biggest things when you're playing there. You got to worry about him.
Since 1973, when Tom Osborne took over, Nebraska's been involved now in 17 of these Big Eight showdowns, most of them with Oklahoma, the last two with Colorado, and Nebraska has won only 5 of those 17 Big Eight showdowns. Bill McCartney with a huge win. He has a big leg up on the Big Eight title and the berth in the Orange Bowl as his Buffaloes go to 8-1-1 and hand Nebraska's first loss of the year. The Cornhuskers now 8-1. The final score, Colorado 27 and Nebraska 12. For Mike Gottfried and Kevin Guthrie, Sean McDonough saying so long from Memorial Stadium in Lincoln, Nebraska.